By the time the presentation gets up, let me thank ICSI for this opportunity, and let me thank Mr. Mahesh Athole, who I considered always as my guru in this profession, because I have always looked up to him from my day one of company secretary career. So thanking him in particular. And I'm aware that I'm standing in front of galaxy of knowledge and all respected and experienced professionals. I don't want to be sounding like too technical person. I've worked mostly in IT companies, but that doesn't mean I will talk a lot of technology here, and I don't want you to have a perception about me that I understand a lot of technology. I'm probably 0.1, 0.01 bit better, because I'm closer to the technology possibly. That's the only idea I see. Here is a presentation that I've prepared. I have been allotted 15 minutes time. I'll try to curtail that within the time span. Couple of disclaimers: being in legal and company secretary profession, on the slide they're at the bottom, possibly you're not able to see that right now. The source of images is from Google, and all IPR is owned by respective owners, and the presentation includes my personal views. With that, I'll start with the subject of artificial intelligence vis-a-vis role of company secretaries. This is just a picture to show that, you know, this is what is going to be. But again, it depends on how you perceive. It could be considered as a fist fight. It could be considered a joining of hands, shaking of hands together over a period of time. Yeah, it's all about how you perceive artificial intelligence as eating up your jobs, or will contribute to your jobs and give you more kind of jobs. Moving on to the next slide, a bit technical term. What is artificial intelligence? It's nothing but a theory and development of computer systems, and such system which is able to perform tasks normally requiring human intelligence. And examples could be virtual perception or speech recognition, decision making, translation between languages and stuff like that. Nowadays, as we know, we all have mobile phones, and most of us have, I assume, most of us have smartphones, which has all these capabilities of translating languages using multiple languages, Indian languages or even other foreign languages, right? So that is all possible because of intelligence that is being playing in the system, in the technology, or through use of technology. There are broadly four or five areas that are being considered here when we talk of artificial intelligence. One is robotic process automation, RPA, which is purely automating standardized or systematic set of processes. It's nothing beyond. Artificial intelligence per se expects you to have, meaning apart from the robotics or the standardization of processes or automation of processes, AI expects you to use smartness. So which smartness is what machine or the program uses, obviously with the help of data that is provided to machines. And third category is Internet of Things, IoT, which is nothing but connecting gadgets through internet. So I'll give you an example. When a cab is running on the road, it's being tracked. And through Google Maps, you can track somebody sitting in the car, or somebody's location is being tracked. I put my location on, my mobile's location on, and then I'm tracking someone else. So it is connecting through use of internet. So it's called connecting Internet of Things, IoT. So there are different methods. Blockchain is another thing that's being talked about, which is a distributed ledger system. I understand these are all technical terms I'm referring, but I just wanted to have you a flavor. There are lots of websites that are available where you can Google it and find it further. But just to make a reference, AI is just one bit of it. People also talk of machine learning, which is part of or a subset of artificial intelligence. So what machine learning does, it basically learns from the patterns or the data that is provided. So for example, even in the medical profession, they are using it nowadays. If particular person has got a cough and these are the, you know, signals coming out from his urine and blood reports, then possibly after scanning through thousands of databases, the machine can decide if this person has detected B12 deficiency or D3 deficiency or something else. And that is how they are trying to use, and machine is trying to learn and contribute in terms of doing things faster and with more accuracy. So in simple terms, it is a computer program designed to perform designated tasks, obviously that usually require human intelligence. It's just a cartoon. Basically, it says that one is asking the other, are you concerned about increase in AI? And the other candidate says, no, I'm concerned about decrease in real intelligence. It's a bit on a lighter side. I just thought I'll put it up. But in the interest of time, I'm just running a bit faster. Where are we today? So I'm now jumping directly to the company secretary profession per se. I will not talk more or specifically about DR12 and DPT3 and, you know, not getting into those nitty-gritties. But at a high level, from a company secretary profession perspective, are majority of our tasks of a company secretary carried through deployment of artificial intelligence today? Answer is no. Maybe some of them are. Some of them are in the process, which we heard in the previous session. Also, the president, sir, advised about a lot of initiatives being conducted by MCA, etc., and ICSI. Why is that? Does the technology not exist? Does it exist? Answer is yes. There is enough technology that is available and which is developing further. That's a different story. But it's not that we don't have the technology at all. So even for the CS profession, we do have the technology. Do we have domain experts? We do have all people sitting here and across the country who are the experts, who are domain experts on the profession, in the profession. Third is, do we have enough skills or funding to use AI more and more? I'm sure we will get funding, and we do have funding. MCA is making investments. ICSI and similar other professionals are making investments. There are a lot of startups that are already making investments. It's all about the drive that we need to have. But largely speaking, if we see this today, there is no drive for shifting suitable work that is carried out by company secretaries to artificial intelligence. I understand what I'm talking will take time. Everything takes time, and typically systemic changes or any such bigger transition will take its own time. It's not going to happen in a day or two. But what I'm trying to highlight is all about the right attitude and willingness and drive to move or shift to the artificial intelligence to the extent it makes sense. I wouldn't call that, you know, human intelligence is not required at all and artificial intelligence will take away humans, not at all. Obviously, we will have different things to do, and which probably we'll discuss in the next few slides. Sorry. Here is another cartoon where the boss is saying, we are looking for someone with your exact qualification, but with a mechanical version. So possibly we'll see some days where some of the jobs will go, that's quite possible. As I was repeatedly saying, any systemic change, any transition will have its impact. Flip side is always there. But as part of that, obviously some people may lose jobs, and that's where the point is, we need to start to learn what we need to do to catch the train, catch the bus on time, so that we don't miss the bus or miss the train. And that is where these could be some scenarios, but we don't have to worry about it, because there will be more jobs that will be available. And I'm sure profession like company secretary, we have a lot to do, which was discussed in the earlier open session, and we all know, I don't need to tell you guys. Basically, we have a lot of governance and other role to play. So don't worry about AI eating up our jobs in the long run. So where would we want us to be? Basically, through use of AI, a company secretary should be freed up from most of his routine or recurring or usual tasks. That's the desired statement. What I'm trying to put up here is not something, some great knowledge that I've gathered on the subject. It's all my understanding and, as I said, a bit of experience. But this is what I expect. This is what I think we should do or we could do with use of technology and with little more willingness and drive to do this. So with the use of AI, we should try and free up our own selves through this filling up of forms. And earlier faculty also covered this. MCA is coming up with a new version which should have pre-filled forms or easy way of filling up forms, etc. So looks like we are on the way. The second point is, technology should assist a company secretary to perform such tasks or actions at a fast speed or with accuracy. So that is what the AI will offer all of us. And third is, contributing more towards actions that require human intelligence or actions and behaviors that cannot be performed by machines. So we have to contribute more and more towards tasks rather than limiting our own selves in just filling up of forms. I'm just giving one example. Don't mean that everyone is just filling up forms right now. Okay, don't take it that way. What I'm trying to say is, we have to focus on the other things where humans can contribute. There are representations being done today, even in front of the authorities. Maybe expanding that. I had a gentle suggestion sometime back. Can ICSI not be a platform for arbitration? Like you have Singapore International Arbitration Center, and likewise, or London International Arbitration Tribunal and Center. Likewise, can we not have ICSI as one of the platforms for members? So that is how it can help. One second. Okay. So there is definitely a great value attached to use of AI, which we need to focus and invest time as well as energy. Here is again another cartoon where a robo is talking now. He's saying, I wonder whose jobs I will eat first. And the answer is, you could never do my job. That's what the other person was saying. And in the third box, it's reading, you are not doing anything, let that sink in. So basically, they're fighting between robo and individuals. It's just to give you a flavor of how it could be as part of the transition. Here are some examples that you might already know. Amazon Alexa or Google Home and Apple Siri, these are some products that we might have seen or heard or, you know, kind of experienced already, some of you, which are examples of technology or AI. And yesterday I was in a legal conference. The discussion was a bit interesting there, where a person said that he just downloaded an app, which was some news app, Times of India. I don't want to blame Times of India, just an app on a news. And what he said is, after he downloaded that app, he's a bit bald person, okay, less hair on the head. And what happened is, he started getting advertisements for hair transplant and those kind of things immediately after downloading that particular app. So that is how technology is detecting you. It's tracking you really well. It knows, it has access to your photographs, right? And that is how he started getting those advertisements. So those kind of things. And this, for example, you have Google Home or Amazon Alexa at home and you are fighting with your spouse, and then you say something and spouse says, okay, she needs to buy something. And the professional quoted there, I'm just quoting from yesterday, he said that he was talking something to his wife in terms of she wanting to buy some stuff, maybe some dresses or something. And immediately thereafter, Alexa popped up that here are the close by shops where you can buy ladies' wear and you can go. And when he got in the car, obviously with the assumption that all gadgets were connected, so car was obviously high-tech car and mobile location and everything was on and all those settings were rightly done. When he got in the car, the GPS immediately showed him the way to where he can go to the shop. So that is where we are heading, or people are already, meaning that's how we have to think. Of course, there is a flip side of it, meaning personally I carry a view, having these gadgets at home, they are literally tracking and listening and recording every single word that you speak at home. And because they get to know, you talk of gymnasium, you talk of something else, and they will suddenly start popping up, you know, because if you have downloaded some app, then it will suggest you, why don't you try this gym app or, you know, exercising and this thing, because you're talking. So they are literally tracking. So we are being tracked like nothing, meaning nothing before, and probably we don't know where we are landing. And I've heard or listened to some presentations around risk part of it, which are information security and data privacy and stuff like that. I'm not diverging there, but there is a lot to talk in that space as well. The last one is another example which some of you might have experienced on a video game. What AI does is the computer plays like an opponent or another player. That's nothing but a technology. He's given some pattern of information. You're playing chess online, and then he knows what move he has to make against a particular move. So there is all data loaded already in that example. Now, I could think of some pros and cons of this. So what AI will do or is going to do, in my view, so it is certainly a technical upgrade. One may look at it as a negative point, as cost is going to increase initially for the investment of funding, but frankly, I don't see that as a much of a long-term negative point. Work with fast pace and more accuracy, obviously that's the advantage, but expectations of clients will go up. Expectations of your bosses, if you are in employment, will go up. So that is what the negativity, again, there is a flip side to everything, but I believe we have to be prepared for that because that's the responsibility we play. Third is routine tasks taken care by machine, which is good, and possibly no more jobs for basic areas that get automated. Possibly, think of typewriters. Do you need typewriter or typist in your office today or where you are employed? Answer is practically no. And that is how the change is going to be, or the transition is going to be, in my view. Less paperwork, obviously I don't see any cons against that. Time availability for strategic and more important work because of routine work being taken care by AI or the technology or the blockchain and other pieces. I think that's where you can, you'll be able to contribute more and more time for strategic or other important areas of work. Data analytics and automation in legal research or in governance and, you know, reminders for compliances, that automated things. We already have tools. I'm not saying this is yet to come. There are certain things which are already available in the market. Some of you may have used it. There are sophisticated tools where you get automated reminders for compliance with due dates well in advance. You can set triggers, you can set escalations. If some compliance was not done on time, then the escalation goes to a manager or some other person, and that is how these things are already in place. The next one is less time and energy spent for administrative tasks or paperwork. New job opportunities, I think I already covered that, and key updates or actions for client. That is where I see more of a responsibility and a benefit to client. Because of AI, possibly you will be able to track more and more data that is happening in the world, any notification, you know, circular comes up. AI maybe consolidates all the circulars and then gives you a snapshot of what is the conclusion. So those kind of things we are expecting from technology. A few actions that I believe could be converted into AI, and some of those cannot, in my view. So on the left-hand side, we have actions that are possibly converted or convertible into AI or through use of AI. Drafting of resolutions. I know today even we copy or paste drafts from the Word or, you know, whatever format we use. However, AI will start drafting minutes. But I still believe if your company is, meaning where your client is or you are working, is a company which just drafts resolutions as part of the minutes and doesn't write detailed minutes, possibly the job will be done much faster. If your company has a practice of writing detailed minutes, then possibly your value add is still necessary as to what discussion happened. Now, there again, technology has an answer where people say that because of the audio and video recordings, technology will capture, will extract what the discussion was and will again put it into minutes. But we are yet to see those versions, or we are far from there. But having said that, I still believe as human beings, we can still contribute into what all detailed discussions that happened and capturing those as part of the minutes. Next is record keeping based on data input available in electronic format, because everything is available now, that input is already ready, and that's something convertible. We are talking of pre-filled forms, and some of this is already in use. However, we still need to review those forms or those documents or records. We have to audit it. We have to give confirmation, attestations, validation. So all these processes still live with human beings. And I don't think we should allow, maybe partly it could still go where technology is starting to review the documents for you on your behalf, but again, partially, I believe, not fully. Drafting of standard letters to stock exchanges. Say, for example, you are a company secretary in a listed environment or in practice serving for a client which is a listed company. There are some standard set of letters where it could be a covering letter to stock exchange, and then AI can help you building those and making those things ready. I understand some of you may say today even we are using templates, so no big deal. But this could be done a bit faster and a bit more sophisticated in a sophisticated manner. Filling up of forms based on inputs available, that's about pre-filling. So this is just an illustrative thing. At the end, what I've tried to say in the blue strip, which is if we need to expand this AI to other areas. We are mostly talking about company law, which I know which close to everyone's and my heart as well. But having said that, I think it's important we start expanding this AI or deploying AI for company secretaries in other areas as well, other areas of practice. In my view, human intervention will still continue. It's not just technology will replace our brains. As I mentioned, we need to, or we would be in a position to continue to add value in advisory services, use of data analysis for better governance. So system will provide us data and analytics, some reports, etc. But we have to use it for better governance, representation before authorities. That's still not automated. Robots are not going there and, you know, representing. However, interestingly, there was one case discussed yesterday in a conference that I was referring, that there was some accident that was carried out in Germany where robo was handling some machine, and it was accident caused by robo and someone got killed. Now the legal question is, who will we file case against the robo, against someone who manufactured the robo, against someone who built the technology? Even people are talking about driverless cars. Now what if the car, there is some malfunction that happens, somebody tries to do mischief, right? We have enough people on the earth who will still try to go in the wrong way or will want to have those motivations. And what if the driverless car is malfunctioned or gets malfunctioned and dashes or hits somewhere else? Who you file case against? So those are some legal questions possibly we will have to answer, and the legal system needs to work on it. But having said that, there are some areas which will continue to contribute as human beings. Certification and audit, I think I already mentioned, completing compliance through digitization. So digitally kind of data is being sent through client to you. You don't have to physically go 10 times, probably go only once where required and stuff like that. Interpreting the law, that's where I think we are required again. While technology will help us in that, no doubt, it will have consolidation of all, let's say, case laws and circulars, clarifications, and it will consolidate and probably help us or drive us to interpreting that. But ultimately, human judgment or something that's still required. Stakeholder engagement and management, which is pretty important, whether you are in practice or in employment, and other services like you are a valuer, you are arbitrator, and those kind of other areas where we can still continue to add value. Humble suggestions, maybe some of these are already in process, to deliberate on areas that can be deployed for company secretaries through use of AI, some of which I have already shared. To engage with startups, if ICSI or individually some of our professionals could connect with startups who will help building applications that are beneficial for company secretaries. So today I see a lot of startups that are into technology domain. I come from the fintech industry, financial technology industry. There are a lot of startups we connect with for building apps that are beneficial for banking services, credit card, online payments, and stuff like that. Likewise, I think we should encourage and connect and invest time, energy, engagement with those startups who will help building apps or some technology for our profession, and have execution focus. I think that's really important. Artificial intelligence cannot match professionalism, experience, judgment, know-how, and skills, which are still left with human beings. On a lighter note, it is also said artificial intelligence cannot match natural stupidity either. So with that, I will want to end. Here is a, I am not sure if I'll be able to play this. I can just narrate what it was. It is a Volvo car video where the car is already started recruiting people. The car recruits people. I have listened to what I'm saying. The car is recruiting people. So what it does is, this video, maybe you'll find it on Google. Basically what it does is, the candidate sits inside the car and the technology speaks. So technology already has the data about the candidate. So he says, the car says, "Hi Kiran, I know you are applying for a company secretary job, and I know you are wearing a white shirt, so looking nice," something like that. Are you under stress right now? Then I will say, yeah, maybe bit uneasy, uncomfortable. Okay, let me play a piano music for your comfort. Then the piano music, the car will say, ring, okay, play. after which car will bring the machine part on the screen, on the digital screen inside the car, and ask questions, show me this part of the machine, and the individual has to click there, and then basis of those answers, on the basis of those answers, car will select the candidate. And that technology is already there. Volvo is using it. They presented it in Brussels in the Auto Expo, and that's something we are heading to. So I think this was just an interesting example. I thought I was not sure if I'll be able to play the video. Can we? If we can, no, okay. So there is some technology challenge look like, or in the interest of time. So thank you so much. I know I've run quite fast, but I hope I could do justice to the topic that I was allotted, and thanks once again to the ICSI.
Thank you so much, Kiran. You really finished up in a timely manner. Thank you. Without taking more time, I would request Harish Jani, practicing company secretary from Bombay, to please come down and share the vision.
Good afternoon, everyone. I thank ICSI for giving me this opportunity to make a presentation before you on the subject AI and vis-a-vis profession of company secretary AI and other emerging technologies. The previous two speakers have already covered most of the part, so I will just touch upon whatever I can add on this. These all are proposed to be covered under the agenda. World leaders, what they want to say on AI, how much IT, AI is being given importance by world leaders. That covers our Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Modi ji, who has said, make artificial intelligence in India and make artificial intelligence work for India. The road ahead for artificial intelligence depends on and will be driven by human intelligence. Mr. Donald Trump, President of USA, has said continued American leadership in AI. They believe they are leader in AI in world. So to continue that, AI of paramount importance to maintaining the economic and national security of America. They have got a DARPA, which is a Pentagon's arm, which is pushing government for making more advancement on their defense and other AI related. So in February 2019, President has issued an executive order saying that how America can maintain its leadership. So that is AI for America. If you click on to AI.gov, you will find that entire document. China has said China must develop, control and use AI to secure the country's future in the next technology and industrial revolution. Putin is also not lagging behind. He is saying the nation which leads in AI will rule the world. So this is the importance of AI around the world. Next, how artificial intelligence, that has already been defined by everyone. So I will just would like to add that AI is considered, it's an evolving topic. And what a human being can do and a machine cannot do is considered as AI. Under AI, if you say over a period of time how it has evolved, in past just search engine giving us natural language searching, that was considered as AI. Now it is a common thing. And playing chess is also considered a common thing. So it is not no more considered as AI. There are other technologies like blockchain, data, RPA, APIs, IoT, augmented reality, virtual reality, and regulatory technology. Regulatory technology is nothing but use of technologies in regulatory compliances. So they have got the two parts, RegTech 1 and RegTech 2. RegTech 1 is use of technology by the entities in compliance and reporting to regulatory authorities. And RegTech 2 is the other part where regulatory authorities are using technology because other side is using the technology. So use of technology, that is RegTech 2. Now, as Bhaskaran sir has said, that is RegTech 2. MCA is adopting AI now. Now we go to machine learning steps. So machine learning is broadly having supervised learning and unsupervised learning. And now in January 2018, Google came out with AutoML. So let us understand the seven steps in normal machine learning process. These are the seven steps. We see 1 to 7. All has to be done through the technology experts in artificial intelligence. Then machine can do the machine learning process. However, with the AutoML introduced by Google, you have to do only first step, and in the last step, you are getting the prediction ready. So ordinary people with a very less expenditure now can have access of machine learning process. Let us go to next step. What is the role of a company secretary? It's a compliance, governance, consultancy, advisory, and cross-profession under which various areas are given. Now, let me go back again in chatbot. I have prepared a small demo on Spice chatbot. Which answers whatever we ask them. I train him for about 13 questions. So whatever we ask him, he will reply to us. So is it mandatory to file EMOA and EAOA? It has given the reply. More you train this machine learning, more you train them using natural language processes, more you train them, more they will be given able to give you a reply. Going further, in compliance with government, there are various platform, technology platforms available. Regulatory for form filing, disclosures and submissions, although in India few platforms have come up, but they are not AI powered, they are in analytics tools. Now in foreign countries, compliance.ai is there on spring, audit expertise in auto audit and other due diligence processes and KYCML. KYCML is so important, you must have read in last 15 days, various banks have been penalized for failing to comply with KYC and AML by RBI. And penalty ranges from in crores of rupees. Sainji is one of the Indian startups which helps overseas European companies in their digital and KYC compliance. One more artificial intelligence branch which is emerging and it is a trend to be followed in AI is explainable AI. Explainable AI, we can understand in a way that it explains how the machine has done the decision making process. So tomorrow, if the user is asked by the regulatory authority saying that in what basis you have arrived at this decision, then explainable AI will give the reply. Microsoft has developed a configurator of holography, Microsoft 365, Cortana, AI, Microsoft Graph, and that helps in conducting the board meeting by using the technology. There are various other platforms. Toffler is an Indian platform which is using database on MCA platform and helps into using AI. It is helping to decide the interconnectivity of entities. There are other cross-profession areas where we can do. This is auditing and certification, accounting and reporting, and taxation. In taxation, there is a tax board used by Australia using AI where it can do automatic filing with individual giving reply to and it for providing details through chatbots. There is a UI path. This shows the how the automatically it does the total operations using artificial intelligence RPA. Robo is opening the email and do the posting. It is downloading the attachment. This is AI at work actually. It takes the company's name, invoice date and number. What is the description in invoice and everything it will do automatic posting. So you have heard AI and what everything about it, but then how it actually works, that is the demo. It will post it to the system. And then we'll interact with your SAP or other ERP software and automatically it can extract and fill the data and or can do the reverse way. So as the time is short, I'm not going through the full. We'll share the link with you and you can see it. Royalty range is another platform which provides for to professional the database for transfer pricing, those who are doing transfer pricing practice, like various prices internationally available, they have got a huge database of professional databases of this covering royalty rates, loan interest rates, and service fee rates. And based on that, it helps in doing transfer pricing. In legal and drafting also, there are various platforms. So Sport Draft is a platform which is AI powered and can draft and sign contracts and do automated contract preparation, or can give you the insight to have a summary and what is actually contract is containing, which are the specific contract paragraph you need to pay attention. These are the same way setting up business is autonomous in foreign countries along various jurisdictions. Automatically it incorporates the company for you, and you have to select, it will do the cryptocurrency issues, which is not permitted in India by under the regulations, but in foreign countries it is permitted. They will raise the funding for you also using that. Polymath is a platform which is decentralized protocol and makes it easier to raise capital and create security tokens. This is a new concept beyond cryptocurrency by converting shares into equity, existing equity, or you can straight away issue security tokens, which is US SEC compliance, and in other countries also it is allowed. Now, other new opportunities. Various authorities have come out with regulatory sandboxes. Regulatory sandboxes has been issued by SEBI, has been issued by IRDAI, and also has been issued by RBI. This provides startups to work under a very protected area where few restricted number of consumers are allowed to consume their technology and find out the uses, what are the plus minus points, and have improved upon that. And they are, although not totally exempted from legal provisions, they have to comply with legal provisions, but they are protected by the regulatory authority. Perhaps if it is possible, Bhaskaran sir can guide whether regulatory sandbox can be possible under Companies Act. There are smart contracts which are blockchain based. Smart contracts is one big area for companies secretaries to be in practice. Smart contracts are blockchain based, most popularly Ethereum blockchain, which contains the pre-programmed coding, and which are either executed once it is that event arises, or time lapse. Like if it is a rental agreement, it will automatically debit at the beginning the security deposit to the account of the lessee and credit to the account of the lessor. Like that, it automatically does the task. And it is for the company secretaries who are legally expert to sit with the coder and explain him how it should be drafted. There are DigiLocker system, data.gov.in is a site where you have got a plethora of data, APIs and other technology based applications available, and utilizing that, one can exploit it and do data monetization, and various uses are available. Regulatory authorities like SEBI, RBI are already using artificial intelligence, stock exchange, BSE. It was reported sometime back that they have tied up with one Swedish company for use of artificial intelligence to keep check on market movement. Now these are the areas. Arbitration, it has been referred to one of the promising area for company secretaries. Arbitration intelligence is a platform which helps. It's a international arbitration platform. Authorities world over are using AI in a big way. Arbitrator intelligence helps in finding out who are the fit arbitrator in this case, what is their history, and using the data world over in international arbitration platform, they recommend who should be the arbitrator fit for this purpose. Same way, Smart Settle and Resolution Cloud are the AI powered platforms which helps in automatic resolution of the disputes, where it is there are parties who are only one party, there are not multi-party. They come to the, they are bring to the conclusion by pushing by the artificial intelligence to have an amicable settlement at certain level. And those who are doing NCLT practice, on the horizon, 5 years later, perhaps there is some risk for you. IBM has developed IBM Debater. That is a computer which automatically debates. It goes through the entire data set world over, which is available on net and newspaper and other things on a particular subject. It becomes so much expert, and it can argue either in favor or against. And you may be there. There are a lot many debates have been organized by IBM on that. Particularly Harish Natarajan, who is Indian expert and debater, he has already defeated that computer. Plus there are GDPR. On GDPR, India now, Personal Data Protection Act is coming, and perhaps in this session of parliament it may be passed. There are internationally for GDPR, there are various tools available, and One Trust is one of the sites which is offering the AI-powered solutions for GDPR compliance, like maintenance of privacy of vendors. If you transfer the data of vendors to vendors of your consumer, how it should be protected in every field, how data is to be protected, that all has been done through AI and other technologies. Article Forge, it is one of the interesting platform where it automatically generates article within less than 30 seconds based on all the information available on the net. We can use this article software, article writing software, for our producing management discussion analysis, board of directors report, certain paragraphs which requires more information to be put in, and these are all verified. All these have supported. Harvard University, Stanford, Oxford, all they were supported. I'm just running through because of lack of time. It has got deep understanding algorithm. Automatically writes the unique articles about any kind. Under 30 seconds, it writes the article using the all the information available on net. So car insurance is the topic. How, in within how many seconds it will write the article? So article is ready with photo and everything. So what company secretaries should do to keep them updated and relevant in the time to come? Previous speaker has already explained in length, so I have just summarized things and I would not like to say more on this. With this, I conclude my presentation.
Hello. Good afternoon, friends. We had this wonderful session on artificial intelligence as well as the role of the CS. And I personally believe the intelligence can be a part of the professional's curriculum, or we can use this artificial intelligence by this natural human being. This can never be replaced the professionals, because the intellectual things which we apply, the machines cannot apply. So we need to use this carefully and very intelligently, so that this artificial intelligence can be a better way used by the human being and we as a professional. Thank you so much, first of all, Bengaluru, Nama Bengaluru, for giving this opportunity to the institute and holding of this workshop. Thank you, my all the speakers, for this session. And we did had a good session. We also feel when we saw this Apple Siri or Google or Amazon, these all are using the artificial intelligence. And the algorithm in the last, which was commented by Mr. Haresh Jani, you search out some particular words on the Google, anything like Feku of India or the Papu of India, you'll find some particular figure, particular face, all this. So these all works on the artificial intelligence. No one recognizes them in this manner, but these are certain things which we can find out. Thank you so much. I would, as a concluding mark, I would call upon to Shri Ganapati Bhatt on behalf of the Institute to please come forward and award Mr. Bhaskar with the Shahid Ki Beti certificate. Ganpati is vice chairman of SIRC. Past chairman of SIRC. Certificate. Yes. I would request Sri Hari Babu Tota, past chairman of Bangalore, to please come forward and award the certificate to Kiran Chetali. I would request Sri S. Raghavan, please come forward and honor to Mr. Haresh Jani on behalf of the Institute. Thank you so much. Friends, I came from Bombay and Bangalore is very close in terms of the alphabets. It's hardly 1.5 hour journey, but from airport to here is 2 hour journey. So it's a tremendous task to be there. And I, being new to the council, getting love and affection from all council members, I'm guided by these people. And I feel like what you feel when you are only one sister among 14 brothers or only one brother among 14 sisters. So I'm like that, the only odd man out who's into employment. And my all friends, my all council colleagues are into practice, but they give me a lots of love and affection. Thank you so much. With these words, I invite my friend Vinit Bhai to please come forward and take charge of the next session.
A very good afternoon to all of you. After the artificial intelligence, now we are entering into the representative services. And the last session of this 20th National Conference of Practicing Companies Creative, that is NCLT, the special session, and to do the honor, we have none other than the two high and esteemed dignitaries with us. Dr. Ashok Kumar Mishra, the member technical, NCLT, Bengaluru. On behalf of the fraternity, on behalf of the institute, I request him to kindly come on the dais. We have the another one with us, our own beloved practicing company secretary and a proud member of the institute practicing at NCLT as well as CLBs and other forums, past president, Sri Nishar Ahmed. I request you, sir, to please come on the dais. Friends, as I told you, we are entering into the last technical session of this conference. And the theme we had, this expanding dynamics of the professional excellence. So when we are talking about NCLTs again, something which has expanded the horizon of professional services, particularly to the practicing fraternity, giving a lot of space to do the advisory and representative services. But at this same point of time, we have to see that how effectively we represent and how effectively we take on the competitions being given to us by the for other professionals in these segments who are also with us on the floor of NCLT. In this session, we'll try to understand the nitty-gritties of the practice of NCLT. We'll also like to understand whether we are going with the very much objectivity of NCLT with the southern part of the country. We have seen R. Gandhi versus Union of India when we started. And this NCLT has come up after a lot of judicial scrutiny, balancing the executives and judiciary function. I'm sure this NCLT, after it has been enactment in 2014, is going with this objectivity. We have seen, sir, certain initial hiccups, challenges relating to the infrastructure issues. I would also request and urge upon to our honorable technical member to throw some light by which we can be all assured that in time to come, we can have a speedy disposal, which is the ultimate objectivity of the NCLT, along with two, you know, ease the burden of the higher courts. So again, whether it is going to give all kind of the solutions or again the things are going to move back to the same courts and after appeal and appeal, or it is going to be an ultimate forum to decide the very important economic decisions and affairs of the corporate sector, which is expected to do. This is the basic objectivity of the NCLT. With this, I am not taking much time because after this session, we have closely validity session also. So I would invite first Dr. Ashok Kumar Mishra to kindly share his words and wisdom with all the participants. Sir, please. I invite him formally. I request Mr. Vijay the treasurer to come forward and do the honor of Angvastram. Angvastram, yes, please, sir. Angvastram to Nisarji. Would you like to continue from here? Okay, fine.
ROC Karnataka hai, usko bhi pleasantry de denge.
Usko? Kya de denge? Baad mein de denge na.
My professional colleagues, as I see from the face, both sisters and brothers appearing in the tribunal. And I learned one thing today from this seminar, that disclaimer is a word to be started, because it is generally in the foreign country, we start with disclaimer. But in India, it is a proud movement that one of our professional colleagues has started with a disclaimer. So I will have to also adopt the same disclaimer. See, here I have come as an individual professional to share some of my views, as was requested by your Bangalore chapter and Central Council members to share some of the views to our professional colleagues. So maybe this view, and when I am sitting on a bench, that view may be different. So first of all, excuse me for that, because the two, it is a different, maybe the coin may be the same, but sometimes you have to have different views. Let me tell you, first of all, let me appreciate, before I go to any other topic or any issue you want to raise, I am having no objection. Whatever I know little, I will try to share you. Basically, let me tell you and compliment the professionals, particularly the company secretaries who are appearing before NCLT. I am happy to see them when they are appearing, when the other side is represented by the top 10 advocates of the Bangalore. They are practicing in the High Court. They are the renowned advocates of Bangalore. When I see particularly a few sisters appearing against him. Every individual has some weakness. So I also feel a professional is appearing, at least he dared to speak when the other side is so strong, practicing for years together to become the senior advocate and has got all the background of cases in his mind, whether from Company Act 56 or thereafter. So I feel proud for that particular sister or brother. Let me tell you, you all are doing good, but like I am a third party, I am seeing from a different angle. My job, let me tell you, the job of a member or a judicial job, I feel, sometimes no doubt it is difficult, but I learned in one of the mock interview where I was also one of the member in the selection committee along with a few high court judges, I found one thing which I think that I can mention to you. You know, the job of the judge is very comfortable, because the petitioner counsel and respondent counsel both will argue, both will provide the material. You have to look at those material and you have to speak on the subject. Or you have to write whatever you want to write about that. So backup material is provided by both of you. It is not unilateral. Unilateral is only in a very few selected case. That is also not unilateral, because you will get a backup like some of the provisions 230, 232, merger amalgamation, or take section 66, 68. So these types of section, you will get some report from our Ministry of Corporate Affairs represented by our ROC, Registrar of Companies and RD. So the judges' job are much more comfortable. Perhaps now I feel why I worked as a CFO and director of finance and perhaps wasted a lot of my time in that. Because that job is difficult. As my one of the friends was telling, in the artificial intelligence, somewhere he was mentioning that lot of data. Let me tell you, I have attended one of the conference where I, along with Mr. Binod Rai, ex-CAG, you know, he's a famous man, was there. So the next day was the board meeting of a particular organization where I was director of finance and CEO, CFO. So when one question came that why not there should be much IT, information technology should be strengthened, this should be strengthened, we should bring so many types of checks and balances, all those things were developed. Even this terminology also appeared, artificial intelligence. Next day, after hearing all these things, there were 200 or 250 CFOs were there. I was also one of them. So when they asked me, what is your view? After hearing all of them, I told them, I feel whatever I carry 4 or 5 input in my Scrabble pad is only of use to me at the time of the meeting. No data, big data, nothing is required in a decision making, because when you are taking decision, you have to keep only 4 or 5 factors in your mind. Processing is always done. These are all the methods of processing. You have to, in any case, adjust those processing material and then to tell. So next day when I came in a particular board meeting where I have concurred the proposal, I myself ensured that this proposal gets rejected in the board. Maybe some company's 250 crore project was lost. I am helpless. Why I am telling you, that's why, as an example to all of you, don't feel fear from artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence or any computer, let me tell you, as a CFO, I was fearing in keeping the debit card and credit card. Because the person who was designing the most complicated system in aircraft manufacturing, he got into some amount was withdrawn from his account. Knowing myself, the chairman of State Bank of India, I told that this case has happened, madam, see how you can help. After a few days, I got the report from her that, Misra ji, if I do anything, because his wife was also drawing money from the same debit card. Then I asked that person, he renowned scientist. He told, Misra, ladka bhi nikala hoga mera paisa. Then how I should catch hold? Bole, nahi, nahi, lekin ye paisa family member ne nahi nikala hai. It is difficult because once you file FIR, some formality is to be done, their family will be in trouble. So I was not keeping it. Now I have started because new government, new system. So let us accept some of the system. Now coming to the issue of NCLT, let me tell you, as a professional, first of all, let me tell you, company secretary has, although you are in number, maybe 58,000, 59,000. I am from a profession where I was just glancing Google at that time, found 2.85 lakhs members. Now, even I am from 2.85 lakhs, I saw advocate, they are 1.3 million. Now, considering these things, you see, what is the scope that has been opened to you? You can appear in almost all the tribunals, not only in NCLT, direct, indirect tax, all the tribunal you are eligible to appear. Now you have a market, what I understand, maybe some fallacy somewhere will be there. Then you can also do, lot of jobs have been provided in SEBI setup, SEBI regulations for listing of companies. Whether 22A, I think that form is also to be certified, corporate governance form you have to certify. 5 crore and above, everybody will have to keep company secretary, listing company, around 5,000 company, listed companies are there, you are. So you have got lot of market. Market is not the dearth. Dearth is my capability. And let me tell you, when you are appearing in any tribunal, including in NCLT, particularly I will tell you from NCLT view, what you have to learn or what you have to pay attention slightly more, how to present your matter. You have, let me tell you frankly, because sometimes I have to be in a gathering of high court judges also, both here in Chandigarh, and I saw what is required is how to present the matter. Suppose bench is not in a proper mood, then it is better to take adjournment. I am telling you with a disclaimer, because here I am speaking as a professional man. Now, secondly, I have seen some of you, even in the when the bench is not in a proper mood, you still want to argue on that day. Are you might have prepared well, but this is not the proper movement. Secondly, I will tell you, when you appear in a case, first prepare your case, how to present it. There are 2-3 ways I have seen very, very senior advocates appearing who are renowned in all India level. There are some of the advocates will start from relief and read from the petition. That is one way. Another way, you have read like an examination, you have kept all the facts in your mind, you have also prepared what are the likely counter questions that are likely to come up. Then you speak in your chronology. Although I know, even in my bench when you are speaking, my brother may sometime abrupt you. No, no, this is not correct. But you peacefully go on presenting the issue without any fear. It is not that you are committing any mistake. So, and whatever you tell must be backed up not only by your data, by your input, but even by superior court citation. Maybe parallel benches decision may not be of much help to you, but if you are considering on an overall basis, so perhaps like NCLAT, Honorable High Court or Honorable Supreme Court, these are the references that will be better. Let me tell you, even in the same case, I have seen senior advocate, both are citing the same case, pro and against. Possible. You have to learn to grasp the thing, whether you are appearing from petitioner side or from advocate side. Sometimes I feel even the petitioner starts his initiation as a respondent. I feel perhaps he has forgotten by chair he changed or what, but not, because this is the way he starts telling his weak points and then he goes to his strength when the case is not very strong. So you have to articulate the things. It is more of articulation, number one. Second is your preparation, because preparation is a must. Now coming to my professional colleagues' question, whether the NCLT, there will be again a backlog or no backlog. Let me tell you, it is a difficult question to answer. You are already well aware that even if NCLT, Bangalore bench sometimes have decided certain case, it is not necessary the opposite party or the respondent will go to NCLAT. He may approach Honorable High Court. Honorable High Court under the writ jurisdiction, which is a large gamut, they can get a stay. We cannot say that we will not obey High Court. Even I have seen recently in one NCLAT decision where NCLAT is mentioning this matter relates to Delhi, where the jurisdiction was of Delhi High Court. I don't know how Chandigarh High Court has decided this issue. So it is a very difficult question, and only the time will tell whether the NCLT has proved itself successful or not. Let me tell you, I can tell you at the present moment, my Honorable President, Chief Justice retired Mr. Mahesh M.M., whoever is our President, Mr. Mittal, now he has got one thing very clear instruction to all of us, that you have to ensure that whatever the receipt side of your case in the per month it is coming, disposal should not be lower than that.
Let me tell you, I can tell only about the Bangalore. So Bangalore, when we started case, we got files from Honorable High Court, CLB, BIFR. Now today I can tell you with confidence ki our more or less whatever is the closing balance, what we generally tell in the accounting term or the pending cases, are within reach. It is not a very high number, it is a very low number, and because of IA, slightly it will look higher, but it is not high. Means we have disposal at least more than the receipts, much more than the receipts, so that I don't think that a backlog will be created. And luckily in Bangalore there will be only one bench will be in a position to handle, because I was asked last time by the secretary MCA, I told that I feel that it can be done. It is only you will have to pressurize and you will have to categorize the cases in ABC category. Luckily the government has also made few amendments where some of the issues which were earlier used to come to NCLT has gone back to ROC and RD. So I hope if you have any other, but I can tell you again at the, because I don't know, because generally he was telling everybody giving a slip, he has not yet given me the slip. So I thought if anybody has any question also, you can ask me in next 5 minutes.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. In such a confident, sir, and we wish that NCLT is going to be big success, taking forward its very objective. We are with you from the institution side, always as a professional, as an institution, in both work with you hand to hand. With the new member joining the bench, I think the infrastructure issues has also been taken care by the government, and I'm sure that in time to come will not have much backlog with us. With the IBC, we have number of the cases, but yes, in time to come, that also be settled down, sir, because initial loss, when it settled down, it takes the time for anything. And I'm sure artificial intelligence is also not easily going to replace this area, because otherwise we have seen arbitration, we just talked about the arbitration is also being taken care by artificial intelligence, and in time to come, we have sufficient data and information available with us. Maybe the few of the cases will be, you know, on hand will be decided by the system itself. The time will come also. I think it has already started across the globe. If we see that, the many of the courts have already started looking into this. In the US particularly, we have taken note of it, that artificial intelligence is playing a very crucial role so far as the judicial decision making is concerned at various levels. But definitely, Burfest has to, you know, take forward of, to the next level to become master to the artificial intelligence by which we stay. Thank you very much, sir. Now I invite past president, Mr. Nisar Ahman, to kindly address all of us. He is one of the proud members. I have seen him personally, I can tell you, in the many years when he happens to be the student time, who always being appearing as a practicing company secretary, and I feel he is really the role model for many professionals in the region, in the country. I have seen his appearing. So big round of applause for him.
Thank you. Friends, good afternoon. Namaskara, namaskar. It's a pleasure to be here. I'm deemed privileged to be here in Bangalore. And very beautiful the venue that has been chosen. I must compliment the team led by Mr. Rao, and of course, president overall as administrative head and the institute people. Then we have enjoyed thoroughly that venue of this convention. And since morning, I've seen that we started with yoga and meditations. And then we had back-to-back sessions. And then probably I've been given to understand this is the last session, technical one. And then we are going to have plenary, closing plenary. And then we are going to disperse and say bye-bye. Thank you very much. Sayonara. Oh, friends, this topic is so beautiful and so close to each one of us. If I ask a question, I may ask the question that, you know, that we have a kind of everyone. I must compliment to His Lordship, now, who is present here, and give a bird's-eye view. The Honorable Member has given a very, very thought process. And I think everyone sitting in the hall, or those who are not in the hall, more concerned to give an opportunity to appear and argue the matters. But it takes time. Jhuta khele sachcha hoy, sachcha khele birla koi, aur jo koi khele man chit laay, तो होते होते हो ही जाए. माइंड मेक्स ए परसेंट, प्रैक्टिस मेक्स अ मन परफेक्ट. सो यू हैव टू टेक अ टाइम. एंड देयर फॉर फ्रेंड्स, सेक्शन 432 फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन द स्टैट्यूट प्रोवाइड्स फॉर अपियरेंस बाय प्रोफेशनल्स इंक्लूडिंग कंपनी सेक्रेटरी, चार्टर अकाउंटेंट, लॉयर एंड सो फोर्थ. प्लीज रिमेंबर हेंस बिफोर इन 432 बिफोर दैट ऑफ द कंपनीज एक्ट, ऑफकोर्स आई एम रेफरिंग टू ऑफ 19 before that we have been authorized only under regulation 18 of CLB regulations, 18 sub regulation 5 of 1991 regulation. Now you have parliament, and parliament in its wisdom decided to give this kind of duty to this group. Now if this is the scenario, the NCLT is the day. Now we have been talking to about 2002 amendment. Now finally we got the day, 1st June 2016, when we got a new dissolution of CLB, and entire corporate jurisdiction has been given to be adjudicated upon by the National Company Law Tribunal and Appellate Tribunal and Supreme Court. So therefore, in the process, corporate jurisdiction henceforth, before it was adjudicated upon by the high courts, have been given. It was a bitter of that, like merger amalgamation, etc. So we have been now doing most of the cases as a technical part, helping the lawyers to argue the matters in the court. But after NCLT, the entire process which you have been doing otherwise and handing over to the lawyer to argue the matters and appear before, been given also to you. So therefore, this area, forget for the time being for 10-15 minutes, be away from your din, pin, tin, sin area. We used to say din, pin, tin, sin. So this area forms uploading and downloading. This mindset, you move out from that for 15 minutes, and remember the lawmaker has given an onerous task to compete with a lawyer who is there in the domain for last 30 years, 40 years and so, and coming before head to head, sometime argue the matter for the petitioner or a respondent. Another side is a senior counsel is countering. So you have to be prepared what all those mindset. Lordship has already given this part. Remember, this aspect has been, and remember one more thing is there, because our members have been making a claim year after year that we have only 4 benches in the 4 metropolitan, earlier in the old days, Chennai, Calcutta, and then Mumbai, and then Delhi. But today we have 12 benches functioning, and 3 more are likely to be added here, because 31 members have already taken oath only day before yesterday. With the 25 existing members, we are going to have 57 members. Strength out of 64. The total strength of NCLT is 64, out of which the government has decided, government of the day, that let us have a full freedom, and the length and breadth of the country, wherever the high courts resides, must have a bench there. In that quest, 12 benches are functioning as of date, 12 locations. Numbers are many more, because Bombay is having 3 benches, Delhi is having 4 benches. Of course, Bangalore is having only 1 bench, but maybe with the time, if the more matters are coming to. So this will there. Now, therefore, please remember, this aspect is going to deal with various issues. One more bench is going to be added. The list is not there. It's a little later. The Indore bench also been added here, but of course not operationalized. So all this we have been working in the first part, that you know, Amravati is going to be added here because members have been selected. Hopefully, notification may come. And someone has to function for the state of Andhra Pradesh, Delhi de-linking Telangana. Telangana today we have the Hyderabad, and taking out the Andhra Pradesh. But Andhra Pradesh is having us independent bench at Amravati. So with this, we are going to have, Lordship has already mentioned about Mr. Kumar, former Chief Justice, who is heading present. Then we have, this is the bench, how the bench, many of you have been now interfacing or interacting with the bench. The bench is functioning, and you have to argue. There is a members, technical and judicial members, and you have to argue the matter. First opportunity would be to the petitioner side, who has brought this petition before, to adjudicate and to argue the matters. Now in this quest, if you look at this, you know, there are various sections. I don't want to teach you the sections today, but if you look at this as a company secretary, I'm just focusing on the company secretary. These all sections very close to your heart. These all sections. And if you look at this, you know, section 55, it's very close to, I don't want to. So these are all jurisdiction available to you to interface with the tribunal, with this kind of judgment. 130, 131 for opening or reopening the account. 213, 216 investigation matters. 221 again is there. 230, 232, so 230, 240 is there with all of us. We all know that. 241, 240. Typically, we used to see this 397, 398. We have been very well now. Most of us, we have been now gone through because CLB came into being in 1991. Prior to that, we had the CLB, but it was regulated through ministry as a bench officer rules 19, company law board bench rules 1975, which was substituted to 1991. And thereafter, at least 397. This is a new format. And please remember now, the government is very active now. Suddenly, government has found 241 is the weapon to move subsection 2, particularly in the interest of public interest, bringing mismanagement to the NCLT to adjudicate upon whether it is or it is not. So it is a court to decide and then go to the NCLT. But 241, suddenly government is also a litigant here now. We have seen because of not only because of the operation mismanagement coming typically from the minority side or majority side, etc., but government, central government under subsection 2 of 241 is also now coming with the litigation. Many more, I don't want to, you know, come upon. 441 was there, but by virtue of 452, adjudicating authority is ROC now. So most of the smaller matters being adjudicated upon by the ROC. But 441, earlier it was there. We used to be loving to iterate. What we have been seeing so far, I have been traveling to length and breadth of the benches. I have seen and discussions with the as a member of the Bar Association or as a member of office bearer of Bar Association at Delhi. What is gathering is that input is like that. The company secretaries are coming to only talk about 252 matters or something matter earlier we used to say called common financial years, section 2, subsection 41 petition, single matters. But they are very shy upon to adjudicate. I mean, only 5-7%. Now this section 3 years are in existence in NCLT. Remember, why we have not been coming in the large number to work with the NCLT in the matter which is also been countered by the other side, may or may not be the lawyers, maybe other company secretary or lawyer, or vice versa. So at where such adjudication part is concerned, single mention, ex parte matter, they are coming more comfortable. The second part, across there is a mention also from the honorable bench side that members are not coming well prepared. If there is a question being asked, which is a very close to the heart of the company secretary or the person appearing before the bench is the person who is now having a kind of technical, very sound knowledge. What is lacking, that is the communication perhaps, or art of advocacy we used to call in ourselves. But they are not in a position to answer. Dress code. So I'll discuss this issue. These are the few fundamental, Lordship has not mentioned in too many words, but as a practitioner, I must tell my brothers and sisters sitting here in the hall, and those who are not there, message should go, that no nonsense, no compromise as far as the art of advocacy and the court craft is concerned, as far as your the attire is concerned. I mean, business, that is already there. So you have to be very, time management is another gap. If the matter is being listed for 10:32 here or 2:32 here, and you feel that the matter is listed in the cause list, that is number 51 or 17 or 30 or whatever. In Delhi, we used to have a matter up to 80. In NCLT particularly, just day before I was appearing, my matter in the second half was there in 33. And 33 second half, you started from 1 again. So then I can feel, okay, I'll come to around 4 o'clock safely. But what has happened? 2:40, the matter called up. Because the cause list dropped very highly. Because connected matters dropped. So if I am a counsel arguing for party, not reaching on time, what is mentioned, the time is there mentioned in the cause list to be there at 2:30 or 2 o'clock. That is not 2 o'clock, I'm sorry, not 2:30. 2 o'clock, the timing. Then what is happening? You are going to lose the case. And losing the case for your client, not for yourself, and then going to be a bad reputation that you are not on time. Sometimes client may ask, other side is now ready, maybe impose cost on you or your client. So time management is very important. Therefore, friends, now the new avatar has come in 2016 end, and it is concerning every company secretary, whosoever is interacting with me. The IBC insolvency bankruptcy code, and suddenly we found that time management. The parliament has brought a time management, 14 days, 7 days, 6 months or 9 months. These are the four words. But of course, in the between, till the matter has gone to the Supreme Court, then in the matter of J.K. Jute, then we got some kind of a respite to the bench. Earlier, the bench used to do, oh, I have to complete this process by 14 days' time, once it is admitted, 14 days' time to respond. But after this Supreme Court opine, that is not a kind of mandatory, it is recommendatory or directory in nature. So directory part has come, then got respite to the bench. But that respite has gone in the long term, but IBC matter is now disposed of in 2 years down the line. For 14 days, the aspect was similarly, 422 talks of 3 months adjudication of 241, 242 matters. And there is a clear word to adjudicate upon in 3 months' time. If it is not being done, then the president, with the reason to be recorded in the order, another extend more than, not more than 3 months' time. That is the statute today. But Mahesh Bhai, you mentioned to me in the morning that 241 is taken a back bench across the country, not your Mumbai bench only. Since you are appearing very regularly before the Mumbai bench, I understand. But it is happening. I discussed personally as an office bearer, as a treasurer of the Bar Association, to the Chief Justice, who is happened to be the president, and he's aware of it. Everybody is aware of, because of the sudden, and there was no strength with the total 25 people. That was also added, 7 or 10 added later part. With the strength of 15 or 17 members, they have been trying to do this justice at least till the J.K. Jute mail came in the before the Supreme Court, 14 days time, and IBC, every day the IBC coming, 10, 15, 20 fresh matters. Every day before the, so this is the problem. So bench was there and given 14 days time to dispose of, whether to accept or to reject. If you accept, then you have to go for pass an order for CRP, and then you have the IRP to have appointed, if name is not there, to seek permission from IBBI earlier. Now it is rationalized over a period of time. Artificial intelligence has gone into, the general permission has been given to. Now therefore, this IBC has given a lot of time and space, because it was not there originally when NCLT came into being on 1st of June 2016. And therefore this position, but what Mr. Kumar, Justice Kumar has mentioned to us, that after the new team is coming to add into the system, hopefully by July end or August middle, we will having a reconstitution, because that already that oath-taking ceremony has already concluded. 2 days back I was there. Now that there is a 15 days to 30 days time, there is a kind of internal familiarization with the court process. So maybe we are expecting by end of October or end of August or so, we would be in a position to have a constitution of separate company law bench. I've discussed this personally. So your answer to your query which you have raised, I answering that because that we have, did discuss, and court is aware of, particularly president is aware of that, yes, these are the backlog and taken a back seat, 241, 242, and other matters. Hopefully we are expecting by August so or so, end of August or middle of August, we'll be having major city company court to start working on this, and then to have the focus attention on these matters and adjudicate upon. Maybe at that time, 422 could have also been looked into. So with this, friends, if somebody is interested really in this matter, I would like definitely to go through the rules. If someone is interested, I think more of you are interested in appearing before the NCLT in IBC matter, because it's a routine matters. IBC now over a period of time, it is no more now more intelligence to be there. You have a routine kind of thing to be seen, section 9 or section 7 or section 10. 10 has gone. After 29A came into being, 10 has gone. Almost the rarest or rare, I can say, in a month, maybe one case before the one bench, or which is not also zero aata hai. The feedback which is coming from different bench. We are getting a list in the registrar of NCLT at Delhi, seeing that 10 in particular bench, zero. Only 9. And 9 also, reduced. 7 also started receding. But because of the reason that all the system is there. Now, therefore, if someone is interested, and many of you are interested, please go through the site, read these rules. And only 10 to 15 rules remember in your memory. Like sir has mentioned, Lordship has mentioned that we are going to argue the matter. At least you are in a position to remember something when you are going to write exam sheet. Please remember 10 to 15 working rules, which will be going to, and these rules are not, mind it, after it came into being, not much frequently, as being done by MCA under this Companies Act. Lot of amendments every week, etc., is coming. These rules are not that being touched upon so frequently. So if you look at these rules, the rules are divided into 20 chapters, 165 rules, because subordinate legislation is very important. What rules is going to teach you? Sir, I'll just give you a few examples. Like in first time you read, what is Rule 8? It talks about sitting of the headquarters at Delhi and other benches to be constituted. Need not require to remember. The 9 talks about sitting time of the bench, 10:30 to 1 and 2 to 4:30. Not required much to remember. Similarly, 11, very important for all of us, those who are intended or are being now interfaced with the NCLT. Rule 11 is the inherent power, as we used to see 151 CPC. Similar situation is there. Anything and everything you want to get it from the NCLT in the interlocutory application, IA, sometime in Bombay is called miscellaneous application. Every bench's nomenclatures are different. Somewhere CA, but don't forget what is called IA and JIA, right? So IA means interlocutory application. You bring it to that. You give these rules also, a power given to the statute, I mean NCLT, emphatically a very, very serious power. See, I mean, very important power that has been conferred upon. And therefore, you please remember, listing of cases are there. Then power of to exempt are there. It requires one time reading, and then you will be a very good practitioner. Don't repeat the offense of like that, because one day default means going to court. If your petition is not in order, it cannot be listed. It could be part of the scrutiny. So prepare all those things. What size of the paper could be, legal size of the paper. Sometime color is there, but color or no color, we are going to take up rest of your matters, 17, 18 points which you have mentioned, sir. It is all administrative side matter, could be looked into by the registrar or deputy registrar of the concerned bench. Maybe I'll discuss personally with the registrar and also to the president that I was there in Bangalore and I have been given these points, and maybe it require a bench to look into. Don't worry about bench, bhai. It is administrative side, bench sometime 4:30 certified copy, why not 12:30 certified copy, or why not 2:30 certified copy, etc., etc. Now, but look at this para. This is the practical. Petition application appeal accompanied by certified documents and index in triplicate. Now, sometime you bring in two sets. So triplicate, that is a requirement of rule. If you don't do it, and everything is mentioned, please remember, 60% of your drafting would be well attended to if you read the rule. What size, what is the space, what is the left-right margin, what is the right margin, what is the top margin, what is the bottom margin. Everything is there, sir, in your documentation. So part of what is requirement is to please remember this part, and once you are there, once you have to go through, what is the fees to be paid? It is a kind of friend, philosopher, and guide. The rules are going to play a friend, philosopher, and guide to the beginners, those who are going to start or intended to start the career before the appearance before the NCLT. I think these are the scrutiny, it is also there. What is the normal question being framed by the registry before it reaches to the bench? When you mention it, with urgency is there, with the permission, you can mention this matter, but these are the scrutiny generally being now noticed. It is there in the domain, FAQ, in the form of FAQs. Kindly download that. Interface with the NCLT website, and you are getting everyday notice, whatever the order being now, past final order or interlocutory order, this is posted in the website. Have friends with the website, spend half an hour time, and go through different bench practices, how this is happening, right? Everything is there. No need to, wait for the, some Bing citation is going to be there. Only if someone is interested in IBC insolvency and bankruptcy, only 35 judgment of Supreme Court, which give you guidance to work. Prepare that, download the citations are there in Supreme Court. Prepare in chronological order. But all those ratios have been now carved out. Recent one, of course, Swiss Rivens, and later part also. Then you go through the second one, around 100 plus judgment, which are very important, which have been also there, that is NCLT. And then you cite before the bench. If you are prepared with these two, you would be a good practitioner as far as IBC is concerned. So with this, I don't want to take much of your time. Three things are required: duty to tribunal, when you are going to appear before the tribunal, please remember that you conduct yourself with the dignified and self-speed, respect. You give respect to all your colleagues, all the bench, and what is this, all that is there. And similarly, dressing etiquette, then you have the handshake etiquettes and communication etiquettes. Please remember, these are important aspects for all of us to, if I say so, I am reminding to myself that I have a duty towards bench, I have a duty towards my fellow, other side, the opposites council, and I have a duty towards my client. And similarly, I have to, some institute has already mentioned something like dress code, we must follow. Being busy is not the same as being effective. Now you are doing 7-10 matters. Sometimes it says morning, din, pin, sin, tin, MCA portal, upload, download, and then you are also thinking to go to argue the matter of 241. It's not possible. Then you are not justice. You are not going to justice. Then you, what is the requirement here is, prepare a team. A junior could do this work or din, pin, tin, sin work, downloading, uploading, certification, and you take your time. That time which you are going to have 2-3 hours, read these questions of 241, what is all judicial pronouncement, what is IBC matters if you really have some matters. Use your free time wisely and attempt an assignment on priority basis. This is the message. And the myths, one slide on myths, and myths is like that only lawyers can draft. Drafting is the burden. We can't do drafting. You see, this slide I prepare based on my length and breadth traveling here and there, talking to my fellow members, and they say, okay, drafting is a burden. How we can't do? We are more comfortable with the intelligence, artificial intelligence. Ab to kuch karna nahi hai, sirf at wo lagana attachment lagana hai. Ab to naya version 3 mein kuch nahi karna hai. Everything pre-filled. Your job is only 5 minutes. Whether you want to do 5 minutes and without any brain? So he says that drafting is a burden because my petition draft nahi kar sakta. What is this? Then you say, somebody saying, oh, I am the old practicing company secretary, 20 years, 15 years, 10 years practice. I can't do this. I mean, again, this area is difficult for me to enter appearance and argue, your lordship, present the case sometime. I'm not in a position of fable and all sorts of things happening. Drafting is a burden. And then he says, I have not studied the subject. But tell me, who has studied the subject prior to 16th of December, IBC? Who has drafted? Who has learned Companies Act prior to 13th of September 2013 and 1st of April 2014? This Companies Act, new Companies Act came, replacing the entire Companies Act. We have started learning again and again and again. That is a process the management says, learning, unlearning, and relearning. That is a process with which we have to work together. And I'm sure the day is not far when we are going to command the group, and because it is a new era. And I'm sure, and I feel that each one of you sitting in the hall are going to be good practitioners before the National Company Law Tribunal. With this, I must compliment and congratulate once again the Institute and Lordship and the past president and all of you for patience hearing. Thank you very much. We'll give the answer. Yes, please. Yes, please.
Thank you so much, sir, for taking us through the NCLT law rules. And the most important, the myth connected with the NCLT practice that the advocates can only do this, we can do this better. We know our subject very well, that we have to just make the beginning. Now this is the time to have a few quick questions, 5-10 minutes only. Be specific in question, please. Yeah.
Sir, my name is Rajendran. I am a company secretary as well as insolvency professional. This is addressed to Dr. A.K. Mishra, also to Mr. Nesar Ahmed. On IBC particularly, this whole process of finding a corporate insolvency resolution ends when there is no resolution plan coming up, and there is an automatic process for liquidation of the companies. Now, of late, I am seeing that by virtue of a decision by NCLAT, all such cases are referred to go through a Section 230 process, Section 230 under Companies Act, wherein you are again asked to find some kind of a settlement with the members or creditors. And here there is another question whether 29A, Section 29A verification is not mandatory during this Companies Act liquidation process. So this is becoming a new concept within IBC. Companies Act is coming into it. Of course, it's a very good area of practice for company secretaries, but I wanted to request you, sir, to give your insight on this, the new introduction of Section 230 into IBC. Thank you.
Oh, the base process is what you are asking in any case. You know, that's why I have told you, One is counsel for petitioner, another is counsel for respondent. If you tell me to argue in whatever way, I can argue both the things. First, I will tell you, let me be very frankly, if a CIRP process is not materializing into resolution, Section 33 is very clear. The situations have already been provided, subsection 1, 2, 3. In what situation, what is to be done? So you see, going, what I am telling you again, which I have also learned in this process, quasi-judicial process or judicial process, basically, you can't generalize anything. You can't generalize. Because if somebody is asking, again, it is a matter for the tribunal to take an interpretation. If you ask me as an individual, not as a member NCLT, I can tell you my view will be totally different. Because I believe in one thing, disposal and a fair disposal. When no resolution plan has come, the Section 33 is very clear that you have to go for a liquidation, correct or incorrect. This is the provision. Any act or code cannot be overruled by any other procedure or the rules. Act is the supreme. So, what in any case, I will seek the view of the practitioner also on this. But to be very frank with you, that's why in Bangalore bench, and I am thankful to our ROC, Mr. Sanjeevan, he is an excellent officer who always provides most of the inputs well in time. That's why my pending list here is hardly 400. And let me tell you, I also suggest my judicial member, if you, this is the first stage in the adjudication process, NCLT. If I start interpreting like our Honorable Superior Courts does, then you know the basic purpose of INB code will go in vain. We will never be able to do. Say, if in one case, I know still it is running up only one case, because government of Karnataka is pressing that they are going to revive the company, election process was there, all these things were there, they are going to provide some type of, reorganization to that particular structure. Other than that, we are not carrying any old cases. We are generally only in 2019. You will not find anything of 2017, 18. Only one that case is still in my memory, or maybe odd 3, 4, 5 cases can always be where it has gone to Honorable High Court and State. So be clear. In any case, I am giving this thing to Mr. Ahmad to answer you in detail, maybe the way you want. But to be very frank, I am very frank because I have attended a particularly, I was asked when INB code came into force, at that time I was asked by IIM Bangalore. So, some such questions came. And bankers were also there, general manager and above, from public sector banks. So, a person asked a question, why INB code was necessary when we were already doing all these things? The bankers provided a very good answer to them. They told, if we do the same activity, we can also do. If we do, CBI, CVC, all will be after us. When the same thing is done through a judicial process, we are free. That is the only answer I can tell you. Okay? Thank you.
No, as far as that part is concerned, you know, 230 and 232 to be also invoked in between. You see, in the course of one judgment is there in February 2019, judgment of NCLAT. That is a landmark judgment of NCLAT, followed by 7 more judgments has come. And particularly as for the view National Company Law Appellate Tribunal is taking now, the role of IBC is to have the resolution and on a going concern basis. So even if the Section 33 Lordship has mentioned about, if nothing has done, plan has not been agreed to, or COC has recommended, but adjudicating authority not agreeing to because of whatever reason and failed, then the natural course would be to move to Section 33. Now, once the 33 start, there is a winding up process, there is a liquidator. May or may not be the same RP, would be termed as a liquidator. Generally, by and large, Lordship has been now kind enough to appoint the same person, unless until the person is now, you know, having some kind of dubious character in resolution mechanism, processes, CRP. Now, the same person is now going to be liquidator. Now, when the liquidation commences, then and then only, court says it is also going, liquidation is on the going concern basis. So going concern concept continue. This means now the promoters are coming into picture, even if 29A barred during the process of phase A, that is not to file the resolution application, is debarred because of whatever reason, 29A. Then to come to the picture of arrangement, if he is coming with a proposal before the creditors and the, you know, equity holders, etc., 230 and section 231, then he can prove as a going concern, or somebody else can buy out with the employees, etc., everybody on the going concern basis, the organization, even if the company is under liquidation. So these are the things. New dimension, 3 days back, one more judgment has come, which you must remember that if the company is now there, the property is now attached to by the enforcement directorate or some other judicial processes, then the liquidator, in the process of liquidation of the corporate body, cannot ask the party to release that.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Please appreciate, for me, I'm duty bound to complete the session in time. It is mandatory for me, it is not directory, because we have the another session. We can have only one or two questions. I know very interesting, very interesting discussion is going on. So I invite my colleague on the council, Mr. Chetan Patel, to kindly give the formal vote of thanks. Sorry.
Friends, NCLT, National Company Law Tribunal, which was actually proposed in our old Companies Act 1956, but because of a lot of legal confrontation, it has seen the light of reality in the Companies Act 2013 only. These are appearing at NCLT. We are governance professionals. So it is not a bad thing to dream that National Company Law Tribunal should set an example across the nation. So other tribunal like GST, NCLT and other courts may take example of the good governance. We know justice delayed is justice denied. So it is always expected that justice should be provided in time. So let's support the effort of the government and NCLT. Sir, we Company Secretary Institute is always supporting our members, educating them. We have conducted a lot of workshops, seminars to educate and enrich them with the latest knowledge. So we ensure that best support from the CS fraternity, sir. Behalf of ICSI, we are thankful to both the dignitaries for sparing their valuable times. Before final vote of thanks, I request Sri Narayan Swami, past chairman SIRC, to give away Shahid Ki Beti certificate to our honorable faculty. To give certificate, Dr. Ashok Misraji. I request Mr. Feniraj HS, who is a member of Managing Committee, Bangalore Chapter, to give Shahid Ki Beti certificate to our eminent faculty, past president Nisar Ahmad ji. I request my council colleague, CS Praveen Soni, to facilitate ROC Karnataka, Mr. Sanjeevan ji. Once again, I thanks Honorable Dr. Ashok Kumar Mishra, CS Nishar Ahmed, my council colleague Vinit Ji. Thanks everybody for providing a patience hearing.
Friends, good afternoon. I am back again with all of you as we come to the close of this National PCS conference. Somebody said, It is not about the time, it's about the choices. How are you spending your choices? So all of you had a lot of choices, right? One is not to attend this program at all. One is to be here physically but not be mentally present, looking at your mobiles or on your phones. Or you could have spent time with your family, especially today is a Saturday. There were a lot of choices you had. But I must compliment you that all of you took a good choice to be present here, and I'm sure you have a lot of good takeaways. We had some beautiful, thought-provoking, inspirational messages from the inaugural session. Knowledge and good practices from the interesting technical sessions. And of course, we had a very candid and assuring open house this morning. I don't know how many of you were there yesterday evening for the culturals. How many of you were there? I'm sure all of you are touched by the emotional mime which was performed by our Bangalore chapter students. It was a very moving tribute to the soldiers of our country. It was done extremely well. Those who missed it really missed it. After that, most of us went to the dance floor there. We had a great time bonding with each other. As the party ended with party abhi baki hai, but everything has to come to an end. Now we have the opportunity to receive some inspiration and blessings from Pujya Swamiji Tadyuktananda. I would request our President C.S. Ranjit Pandey and our Vice President C.S. Ashish Garg to accompany our chief guest for this session, Swami Tadyuktananda Ji, from Sri Ramakrishna Mata, Bengaluru. C.S. Devendra Deshpande, Council Member, ICSI and Program Director. C.S. Manish Gupta, Council Member and Chairman, PCS Committee. And C.S. Nagendra D. Rao, Council Member and Program Director, to come over to the dais. It's now my privilege. Pardon? I cannot forget who is the Karta. Yes, our chapter chairman. He is the program facilitator, Pradeep Kulkarni, to come over to the dais, please. I'm sorry for this. I think I will blame it on this. No blames. I'm sorry. I would also request SIRC Chairman C.S. Mohan Kumar to occupy the dais. As they come over to the dais, may I request C.S. Devendra Deshpande to give the welcome address.
Very nice thing to see full house at the valedictory session. Many of the programs we are not like very used to see such a big number even at the valedictory session. So I think we all must give you a big round of applause because you all are here for the valedictory session also. And we are really thinking about expanding dynamics of professional excellence. In last 2 days, we have done a wonderful job. We all have discussed, deliberated various aspects of our profession. And I think valedictory session is the session wherein we can revisit our memories, revisit our thoughts. We can discuss various things. We will wrap up this. And most important thing is we will thank all the people who are working behind the scenes for n number of days, all the volunteers. I'm really happy that Bangalore chapter has come up so well in organizing this session. So this is the valedictory session for all of you. On behalf of ICSI, it is again a great privilege to welcome Swamiji from Ramakrishna Math on behalf of Institute of Company Secretaries of India. And I request our president to please welcome Swamiji on behalf of ICSI by offering him Angavastram and a small plant. Yes, yes, please. So I think you all must be eager to listen to Swamiji, our chief guest for this valedictory session. So I take pass on the dais to the comparer for the session. Thank you very much.
This will be given by C.S. Manish Gupta, council member.
Thank you, ma'am. Swamiji, chief guest for the valedictory session, President ICSI, Vice President ICSI, my central council colleagues on the dais, of the dais, past presidents, ladies and gentlemen, very good afternoon to all of you. Let me first thank you all for your participation in this being a mega event being organized by ICSI. And it was really a great event. I must compliment the efforts by Nagender ji and entire team of Bengaluru and SIRC. Big round of applause for Bangalore, SIRC and Nagender bhai. As everything is required to comes to an end, so this program is now comes to an end. But few good initiatives have been taken in this program, and you all had good learning of 2 days, and we had enjoyment as well in the culture evening program yesterday. I hope you will be carrying lots of things for the introspection, and you must inculcate what is required as a PCS in the days to come from each one of us. Friends, few initiatives of the PCS committee has already been discussed, deliberated, launched, released in this conference. Few homework I have got from President and the members, esteemed members present here. Let me share with you few of the things which we as a PCS committee is going to deliver in the days to come. One such thing is that we are going to start with a unique initiative of webinars, and those webinars will be based on the basically on the Companies Act, and the theme would be has been suggested by our Vice President that compliance is not negotiable. So we would be having series of webinars on all those compliance related oriented topics in the days to come. Friends, I would like to share that on the recommendation of the PCS committee, one unique thing has also happened, which is going to be released today itself, that we are now coming out with the Sequital Audit Award. For the first time, like the Corporate Governance Award, we are coming out for our practicing company secretaries, Best Sequital Report, Sequital Audit Report Award for the company secretaries. And we have also started with the preparation and questionnaire for the practicing members. Very soon, we'll be inviting the participation nomination from your side. Would request each one of you who is managing the secretarial audit for their client companies to participate. You can participate up to 5 number of your secretarial audits, and that award would be given at the Corporate Governance Award function. Another thing, homework or the initiative which is being referred to the PCS committee is the scale of fees. We have already started working on it, and very soon I am hopeful that committee would be deliberating on the scale of fees issue, and very soon we would be having the scale of fees for the practicing company secretaries. And that would be a totally independent thing, recommendatory obviously. We cannot have the mandatory thing for the practicing company secretary with respect to the scale of fees. We would be having it on the recommendatory basis, and you would feel like it would be based on the man-hours thing, not on the minimum fees of fees which can be quoted by the practicing company secretary. It would be on the man-hours basis, experience basis, whatsoever specialization the company secretary is having. Based on that, we are working on it. So I am thankful to the President for reposing his trust and confidence on me and giving me that much of, I would say, the liberty as well as the responsibility for organizing this particular conference. Thank you once again, each one of you, for participating in this mega event. Thanks to all of you.
Before I request the next official to give the address, I just have a small announcement to make. I understand the IndiGo flight to Mumbai has been cancelled for information, but we move on with our session. If anybody can throw light on that. Okay. Friends, please check out. We'll move on with the program. I would request a Vice President CS Ashish Garg to address the gathering.
Good afternoon, friends. With the blessings of the Honorable Swamiji, I just want to narrate one incidence of Ramayana. Swamiji will correct it if there is something. Friends, when Valmiki completed his Ramayana, Narad said, it's good, but Hanuman's better. Jab Ramayana complete ho gayi, to Narad ji ne bola, ki ye Ramayana achhi hai, par Hanuman ji ki sabse achhi, Hanuman ji ki better hai. Hum sabko malum hai ki Ramayana Valmiki ji ne likhi hai, Hanuman ji ne koi Ramayana likhi nahi thi. Valmiki ji didn't like that. He asked, how Hanuman's Ramayana is better? Then he founds Hanuman's Ramayana in just 7 leaves of banana. Sirf kele ke 7 patton pe wo puri Ramayana likhi hui thi. The words, the punctuations, the vocabulary, everything was so perfect that whole Ramayana got completed in just 7 leaves. Valmiki started crying. Then Hanumanji asked, why you are crying? Kyu ro rahe ho? Kya hua? Bole, no, after reading this Hanumanji's Ramayana, no one will read mine. Koi bhi nahi padega. Kyunki ye to 7 patton mein puri Ramayana complete ho gayi hai. Then Hanumanji just, unhone wo 7 kele ke patte faad diye aur rakh diye. Then Valmiki ji started more crying. Why you have done that? He said, I have written this Ramayana for my Lord Ram with the devotion. You have written this Ramayana for the validation of the people. You want the recognition, that's why you have written. I don't want any recognition from anyone. So friends, in our life also, there are so many people who have done so many things for us, like a Hanuman. Our parents, our family, our friends, those who are doing so much of work for us without seeking any validation. They are doing all those things with their love and affection. Friends, the same with ICSI also. Our president is doing day in and day out all the work, not for any recognition, just for his love and affection for the ICSI as a Ramayana. All our council members, all our regional council chairmen, all our chapter chairmen, all our past presidents, they have done all their work. They have given their life to the institute, not for any recognition, just for their love and affection. You can become the prime minister of the country twice, thrice, 4 times, but you can become the president of the institute just once. So it's a one life and 1 year. So friends, the message is very simple. All of you are also like a Hanuman for the ICSI. Do your good work for the institute. You all need a validation, your love and your affection. Sometimes you will get the recognition also, but institute is our mother institute, our mother body. So do it, whatever you can do for the institute. I'll just say, for doing this, you need just 3 things. Aapka chintan shuddh hona chahiye, your thinking should be pure. Aapka charitra uchh hona chahiye, your character should be high. Aapka acharan paradarshi hona chahiye, it should be transparent. Achha bane, na ki achha dikhe. Har udaan akash naapne ki asafal gatha hai. Har udaan, jab bhi hum mandir, masjid, gurudware, kisi ke bhi saamne se jaate hain, apne aap hamara man shraddha se jhuk jata hai. ICSI bhi hamare liye waise hi hai, ki har udaan akash naapne ki asafal gatha hai, mandir mein pravesh karne ki pehli shart jhuka mata hai. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram, Jai ICSI.
Thank you, Ashish. It is said stories, whether they are personal, mythological or historical, connect best with the audience. In the beginning also, in the inaugural session, I think you used some references to Mahabharata. Now you have closed it with Ramayana, which are the 2 greatest epics that India has given to the world. Thank you very much for those inspirational messages. Now I would request our president, C.S. Ranjit Pandey, to give his presidential address.
Swami Tadyukyatanandji, chief guest for the session, Vice President ICSI, my council colleague, chapter chairman, region chairman in absentia, Northern Region Chairman, Vice Chairman, past presidents, past vice president, my dear professional colleagues, good afternoon all of you. every good thing has its end, and we are come to the closure of this program. And friends, I'm very emotional and touched by the participation of the audience. Clap for yourself, please. I must compliment you. I must compliment you. I have never seen this kind of participation each and every session, the kind of participation this region, Southern India Regional Council and Bangalore has given. Wonderful. Official vote of thanks will follow, definitely, and Nagendra Bhai will be doing that particular job. But I must give my gratitude and thanks to all my council colleagues for unconditional support for this particular conference. All my regional representative, chairman, Bangalore chapter, Nagendra Bhai especially. And wonderful staff of officials of Southern India Regional Council led by Sara. Wonderful effort, Sara. Friends, there are many takeaways from the 2 days deliberations. And audit and certification, we have chosen as a first topic, accountability. And I can connect with the inaugural session speaker. Skill, knowledge, skill plus knowledge combined is very good, but attitudes is very important. And unless and until there is an attitude, if attitudes goes, then a skill and knowledge has no relevance at all. This is very, very apt for we professionals. And your attitude will make you as a brand, and that will make brand ICSI. Startup, second one. Startup India brainstorming has been done, and what new entrepreneurs are asking from the professional, what they are willing to accept and what they need. I think we as a professional need to understand that what is their need, and on the basis of their need, we should change, we should adapt the changes, and thereafter we should deliver them. Then only we will be able to converge their difficulties into their solution and opportunity for us. That will make a new area of practice for all of us, and they really need it. Then only these startups will become future corporations. Artificial intelligence. Friends, this topic is very, very disputed topic because it is always human versus machine. And somebody says, yes, it will replace human skill. Some says that, yes, human skill is not replaceable at all. I believe in this philosophy that whatever machine, howsoever machine progresses, human will come beyond that, and definitely human skill is irreplaceable. No substitute to the hard work. No substitute to the commitment. We'll have to be hardworking, committed towards whatever we are doing, then definitely there is no defeat at all. NCLT session, always we were saying, Hamara vakt aayega, Hamara vakt aayega. Now time has arrived. Yes, NCLT, we have been recognized, and we will have to deliver best of the services to the corporates. Then only blue coat will be there side by side with the black coat. That is required to be achieved. This particular conference has given me a lot of lessons also, learnings. And I was, and in fact, before that, I will be asking a question to you. How was the conference? Superb. Why? I think 2, 3, 4 takeouts are there. I think theme is not important. You choose whatever theme you want. But yes, speakers and their presentation, their adaptability to the theme, and their preparation for the theme is very important. That makes the sessions great. That is one takeout. Second one is meticulous planning by the organizers. Each and every minute, each and every session, each and every theme must be planned. And I must compliment Saurav Jain from the ICSI for doing this.
excellent planning. He has given the even questionnaire and answers to each and every speakers. This is your timeline. This you need to ask. What are the questions may be asked? Framing, everything has been done. So that is meticulous execution. And then execution of the timeline and deadlines. This is also very important. Presence of the audience is one of the most important thing, and that is wonderful here. Wonderful. Vigilant and interactive audience. If audience will not attract, the speaker will lose the focus, and thereafter session is not going to be wonderful. So it is your contribution during the session has made this particular program wonderful. Again, clap for yourself. Friends, brand ICSI has been made with the dedication and commitment of our past leader, all of you, and we need to respect the brand and embrace this particular brand. Utilize the recognitions, whatever has been gained over a period of time. This has some objective. Whenever some regulator has given the recognition to you, they must have thought that we will achieve something out of this. We need to understand that particular objective before giving the services. The moment we are able to understand the objective of that particular recognition, we will be delivering the best. And we'll have to deliver the best. Then every second day you have to challenge the status quo. I'm repeating this sentence again. I've said in the inaugural session also, challenge the status quo. The way you deliver services and the way you are performing 2 years back may not be good today. So you'll have to change, improve. Competition should be from yourself. Improve it further and further. Every second day, every month, and every year, your services should be different. Each and every member of the ICSI is my brand ambassador of the institute. Define the future of your practice and define the future of this profession. If you will be able to define your future, you will be defining the future of our profession. So with these words, I will conclude with saying that we need to become indispensable to the organization and corporates. And indispensability should be our principle. Thank you very much for your participation. Jai Hind, Jai ICSI.
There are many attributes of a leader, and I believe two are very important, that is gratitude and appreciation. And we very rarely find this in the corporate world where there is cutthroat competition and nobody wants to take time to appreciate. I would really like to thank you, Mr. President. Your speech was laced with gratitude and appreciation for everyone present here and for all the speakers. Thank you very much. Those are signs of a very great leader. Let's hear it for him once more. There is one person sitting here on the stage, quietly doing a lot of work, like Sri Hanuman. I think that's our Pradeep. There's a lot of back-end work which he has done. I thought we should give him the privilege of introducing our chief guest, Swami Tadyuktananda. I request Pradeep Kulkarni, chairman, to come forward and introduce the chief guest.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's my proud privilege and immense pleasure to introduce Swamiji to all of you. Swami Tadyuktanandaji Maharaj is inspired by the life and message of the holy trio of Bhagwan Sri Ramakrishna, Holy Mother Sri Sharda Devi, and Swami Vivekananda. Swami Tadyuktanandaji Maharaj embarked upon this life long, God-centered life of being a monk. After completing his graduation, he joined the Holy Ramakrishna Order of Monks founded by Swami Vivekananda at the Ponnamet, Coorg, center of the Ramakrishna Mission in the year 1995. After his initial training at Ponnamet and the headquarters of the Ramakrishna Mission at Beluru Math near Kolkata, he was posted to Ramakrishna Mission Ashram at Belagavi. In the year 2005, he was ordained as a sannyasi by the president of Ramakrishna Order of Monks at the Beluru Math. He has been serving at the Belgaum Center of the Ramakrishna Mission since 2001 till 2016 and is presently serving in Sri Ramakrishna Vidyarth. Swamiji, it's my proud privilege and I welcome you once again to this August gathering and valedictory session. Thank you.
Request Swamiji to bless us with your inspirational message.
Namashri Itirajaya Vivekananda Suraye Satchit Sukhaswarupaya Swamine Tapaharini. Before getting into the main theme or ideas what I wanted to share with you, at the outset I congratulate ICSI Bangalore chapter for organizing, hosting the 20th National Conference for Practicing Company Secretaries with the theme Expanding Dynamics of Professional Excellence. Excellence, every one of us, we want. But there's a thing attached to it, hard work. I heard from many of these people, excellence doesn't come just like that. So, but you are all focusing on this and having this such a nice program, focusing on the excellence. One thing I would like to add is, you have added professional excellence, but please add personal excellence also. The personal character is also very important. I know it's a sublime, it's underneath. You have not expressed it, I believe. But your ICSI motto, what is there? Satyam vada dharman chara. It's ultimate. I never expected that organization like this can have this kind of motto. Really, I was surprised. And also, I'm very thrilled to be amongst the audience, I mean, the elite people of our country like you. And I heard from across the country you have come. And again, I thank our Bangalore chapter for inviting and bringing various secondary messages like harmony, better communication, better understanding amongst our countrymen through this get together and the national level conference. Swami Vivekananda says, it's a fact of life. Expansion is life, contraction is death. Expansion is a continuous process that brings the growth. So that's the same thing what you have had the theme for this session. It's interesting that you have invited representative. I'm representing Ramakrishna Math. I'm one of the monk of the many. I'm representing an ideal. You have invited a member of an organization who is practicing what is preached by Upanishads. The same sentences what you have taken from the Taittiriya Upanishad, Satyam Vada Dharman Chara. There are many organizations which only preach, but very few practice. Our is one such organization who practice what they preach. So I am proud to be amongst with you all, with the practicing secretaries. That's a nice thing. Coming to the sharing few ideas, I invoke the blessings from the Lord. I'm not going to bless you all. I invoke blessings. See, the Upanishadic statements, what you have taken, that itself is a blessing. If those words are repeated constantly, that itself will bring goodness, greatness, and you'll be closer to the truth. I came with the preparation that I may get 10 minutes more. you know, any speaker for that matter who likes to have it. But I ensured that I cannot go beyond 20 minutes. So I'm just reducing, confining myself to that. I will read few ideas. I think it's some of them you might have heard, but it will be repetition. Repetition of great ideas, truths, great truths are very essential. The another thing is what take home, which you are often using, the modern terminology, would be Vivekananda's thoughts on this Satyam Vada Dharmam Chara. Nowadays, it's said it's good to be printed on a paper, good to be said on the dais, but bad thing to practice. But I'm very overwhelmed to see that many of you people, it's not a mutual appreciation club, but I heard from many of the sources that here are a few small group of people who are practicing Satyam Vada Dharmam Chara. I congratulate all of you for this. Because you're the great inheritors and carriers for our great future generation. Coming to the main topic, I would like to restrict the time. I'll take the help of the paper. Respected dignitaries on the stage, respected dignitaries in the audience, and dear friends, it's very heartening to remember the word Satya itself, because that brings the very existence of all of us. I shall try to explain the import of this extremely valuable dictum of the Upanishad. As soon as we entered, I'm sure all of you might have come to know that it is from Taittiriya Upanishad. We have 10 major Upanishads. Out of that, Taittiriya is one, and which is very close to our day-to-day life. That's why I think your predecessors must have taken those from the Upanishad. This, when the students have completed their education under the guru and are about to go back to the home and to the world to become productive citizens, the guru says these words. It's almost like convocation of the modern day university farewell. At that time, this has been told. Satyam Vada, speak the truth. Dharman Chara, practice Dharma. You have modified according to your need. First of all, we must note that Guru says, speak the truth. He does not follow it with the words, Satyam Chara. Practice the truth. There's a difference. He says, Dharman Chara, practice Dharma. What is this? Thought, word, and deed. Matu, Manasu, Kruti. These are the activities that have received enormous attention of the ancient rishis in India. All human activity can be classified into one of these categories. Although a man is identified by what he thinks, speaks, and does, our ancient rishis did not believe in superficially polishing these things in their students. The entire emphasis of ancient Indian education was on perception. Grahike, Kannadadalli grahike anta heltare, Hindiyalli anubhuti anta heltare. The ancient Indian method of education was not like today's education, gathering facts, learning by heart information. These did not constitute education in those days. The crux of education was, developing concentration of mind. Please mark it. The crux of education was developing concentration of mind. This is the new thought or defined by Swami Vivekananda. little ahead, we can say, training of the mind. With this concentrated mind, they were supposed to see the truth of their own being. The students learnt how mind can be protected from distractions and be focused on what has been discovered as the universal reality in himself or herself and in the world. There is this world that we all see and experience, that is a perception. What is this world? Can we explain its origin? Can we predict its future? Then there is man. In other words, I am there. Who am I? What am I here? What should I do? The entire education of ancient India was geared to answer these questions. It is in this context that this famous dictum arises. The guru has taught the boys everything that he knows. He has taught them what this world is, how to understand this world so that it does not hurt us. World does not hurt us. He has taught them various skills required to be a productive person in the world, contributing to the economy of the society. He has also taught them about themselves. He has taught them who they truly are. He has taught them who truly they are. They have been taught about their bodies, their minds, their relations with others in the society. All these things have been recorded in the Upanishad. The guru begins his convocation address by telling his students that they have to divinize their relations in the world. This is the take-home point. Just to be precise, I'm telling, to divinize their relations in the world. This is a new facet what Swami Vivekananda has given. Their school and college days are over. They will now live in the world and be citizens. They will work in the society at various levels. What should be their attitude? They should learn to look upon all people associated with them as divinity, as gods. Hence, the guru says, Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava. Let your mother be God to you. Let your father be God to you. Let your teacher be God to you. Let the guest in your house be God to you. This is the central teaching of Vedanta. Spiritualizing all human relations. I think it's not going above your head. Very nice. Because you are going back with a great enthu and with great hope and great dreams. As I mentioned before, the activities of a person are the outcome of his perception. What does person see? That is important. Does he see reality as it is? Or does he labor under delusion? Reality is one. This is the take-home point. Reality is one. All that exists is one. There is no multiplicity anywhere. You may object saying that we see innumerable things and beings in the world. Vedanta says that you are delusional. You see wrong. You have hypnotized yourself into seeing multiplicity where actually none exists. All that exists is one being, and that is the truth, and that is Satyam. In fact, another Upanishad calls this fact as the truth of all truths, Satyasya Satyam. This truth has to be told. To whom? Primarily to oneself. I have to tell this truth to myself. Why the same topic has been given by the president of Bangalore chapter or the Bangalore chapter to me is, we have to repeat the truth again and again. You might have heard different several lectures on this motto of ICSI, but I'm trying to give a new facet of the same truth. Now, Vedanta brings forth a great idea that whenever we speak of activity, we need to specify the goal of that activity. Goalless activity is absurd. According to Vedanta, we may have any number of secondary goals for our activities, but there has to be one overarching goal that will integrate all the secondary goals we may have in life. If we don't have such a supreme goal in life, we find frustration in our life at some point of time or the other. This supreme goal of all human activity is to manifest this oneness. To manifest this oneness of all existence, says the Vedanta. Hence, speak out that truth, keep on asserting that truth, align all your short-term goals, your secondary goals towards that supreme goal of oneness, and perform your activities towards manifesting that truth. This should be the take-home idea of this conference. Since I come from Ramakrishna Math, which was founded by Swami Vivekananda, I'm basing my ideas on what Swami Vivekananda had said on these issues. According to Swamiji, this is third point which I would like to draw your attention. According to Swamiji, dharma encompasses all the necessary activities a man does in his social settings. All the activities. If you study Swamiji's lectures from Colombo to Almora, there's a book called Lectures from Colombo to Almora. One idea comes out very clearly. All activities that a man does with respect to the eternal truth within him is called religion. All activities a man does with respect to the eternal truth in the world around him is called dharma. When it comes to the oneself, it is religion. When it comes to the activities around us, it is dharma. Thus, Swamiji effectively disassociated religion from every social, political, and economic considerations. Religion is the eternal relationship between the eternal soul and the eternal God. Our motto is very clear, Satyam Vada. So our every action should be associated with the Satya. Religion is the eternal relationship between the eternal soul and the eternal God. There is no space for anyone else in that relationship. Neither father, nor mother, nor son, nor spouse, nor friend, nor guru has a space in that relationship. The rules of this engagement are dictated by religion. When man has to interact with other people, who dictates the rules of engagement? When religion dictates these rules, mischief enters into society. Let religion confine itself to its own field. Society itself will dictate the rules of engagement in society. Those rules will base themselves on the discoveries of the religion. But no religious leader will interfere in the formation and execution of those rules of social engagements. Since Hinduism has effectively done this in its long history, it has survived. In Hinduism, religion and dharma are totally In Hinduism, the religion and dharma are totally separate. society will frame its own rules and regulations completely unhindered by any influence or interference from religion. Thus came up the ideas of Shruti and Smriti in Hinduism. Shruti includes the eternal ideas of truth in the Vedas, the Satya part in your motto, that is from Shruti. Smriti includes all ideas governing man's behavior in society. The second part of your motto, Dharma, is the Smriti part. In today's language, these Smritis were the constitution of Hindu society. Now, some of you may raise an objection. Should we not base our interhuman relationship on the eternal truth that is in man? In other words, what is the basis of ethics and morality? We all know that ethics and morality refer to the correct social behavior of one person with another. What should this be based upon? Satyam is the truth in me, and it is infinite. Let us keep this idea clear in our mind. Satyam is the truth in me, and it is infinite. Dharmam is the truth outside of me, in the world around me, in the people with whom I interact. And that is also infinite. And Swamiji shows from Upanishads that these two truths are one. They are not two separate truths. They are one. What this teaching means is something revolutionary for this world. There is no scope for anything base or gross anyone anymore. Once this teaching is accepted, it's a question of acceptance and practice. Some of you may be finding it as a new idea. It takes time. I heard yesterday Guru Rajkarji was talking something about this. The new ideas, it will be retaliated in the beginning. Afterwards, there will be sangharsha. The acceptance comes last. So in the same way, this new idea, but you have to try to practice it. All corruptions vanishes when we accept this teaching of Vedanta. Whom will you cheat? Your own self? Because as there is only one thing, whatever exists, everything is one. Whom are you going to cheat? So please think on this. Isn't that absurd? Whom will you hurt or kill? Your own self? Whom will you be jealous of? Your own self? Please think. So you will understand that motto you have accepted for your organization is very, very deep in meaning. I have just explained to you the most basic ideas associated with it. If we get some other opportunity, I would like to share some more ideas. And these ideas are based on the book Karma Yoga, written by Swami Vivekananda. And one more book is Practical Vedanta. The ideas what I shared today, it's in the synopsis of that book. You may refer those books, which are available in our Ramakrishna Math Bangalore and at our other branch centers across the country. If you study these books, you will get greater insight into the motto that ICSI uses, Satyam Vada Dharman Chara. I once again thank all the people assembled here today for patiently listening to these ideas. And also, I thank all the organizers for giving me an opportunity to be a part of this nice program. And in fact, I should say, I enjoyed every minute of my learning from the time I arrived. I wish you all the best. And also, please join hands by living selflessly, taking our younger generation to the greater heights, thereby taking our country to the greater heights, which our elders used to say, our Bharata was Vishwaguru. Now, our target, our vision, our motto should be to make our Bharata as Vishwaguru. Thank you. Jai Ramakrishna.
Swamiji, please accept our pranams on behalf of everybody here for the wonderful message and ideas of Swami Vivekananda, which you distilled so well and gave it to us in about 20 minutes. You connected very beautifully with the theme when you said professional excellence come from personal excellence and expansion is life and contraction is death. You have sat through for 2 days, it's just 5 minutes, please stay back. And we really feel blessed that it was almost a mini discourse, Swamiji, on Satyam Vada Dharmam Chara. It was delivered so well, so many perspectives you gave. I think it makes all of us feel proud that we have this as our motto. Thank you very much. Quickly, I have some announcements to make. There is a video going to be played on ECSIN.
ECSIN identification number, ECSIN. ECSIN is employment-specific unique identification number of a company secretary. Objectives of ECSIN: to monitor the appointment and cessation of company secretary in employment, to bring transparency. ECSIN also provides facility for updating professional address. Applicability: ECSIN is generated at the time of employment as well as at the time of demitting office in any manner. How to generate ECSIN? Create login ID and password on ICSI portal and generate ECSIN. ECSIN will be a random alphanumeric number. No document shall be required to be uploaded. Modalities: one member can have only one active ECSIN at any given point of time. Regulatory bodies and other stakeholders may verify the authenticity of ECSIN by visiting ICSI website www.icsi.edu. ECSIN shall be shared only on registered email ID of the member or through electronic mode. ECSIN mandatory. Coating ECSIN on the documents, certifications, attestations shall be mandatory with effect from 1st October 2019. Enforceability. Any non-compliance with these guidelines shall render the members liable for action under the Company Secretaries Act 1980, read with First Schedule and Second Schedule to the Company Secretaries Act 1980.
I have some two quick announcements to make. ICSI has been conferring the Corporate Governance Award and CSR Award. From this year, in order to recognize the efforts of CS in practice, ICSI shall also be conferring Best Secretarial Report Award. I think we must congratulate the Council for this decision. I hope it improves the quality of all the reports. Another interesting announcement, PCS National Conference is almost come to an end. We are just about 5 minutes away. There's an announcement about the National Convention. It's the most awaited annual event of our institute, the annual congregation of company secretaries. This time, the 47th National Convention is scheduled at Jaipur. Please mark your calendar, November 14, 15, 16, 2019. On behalf of the Council, of course, I request all of you to attend and participate in large numbers. Now it's the privilege of CS Nagendra, Council Member, ICSI, and the Program Director, who has brought this program after 12 years back to Bangalore, to propose a vote of thanks.
Good afternoon. Ellarigu namaskara. My pranams to the lotus feet of Swami Tadduktanandaji, Sri Ramakrishna Matha, Bengaluru, CS Ranjit Pandey, President, CS Ashish Garg, Vice President, C.S. Manish Gupta, Central Council Member and Chairman PCS Committee, C.S. Devendra Deshpande, Central Council Member, and my dear Pradeep Kulkarni, Chairman of the Bengaluru Chapter. It gives me immense pleasure and privilege to propose vote of thanks to Swami Tadyuktanandaji. During Swamiji's discourse, Swamiji talked about important facets of life, and the takeaway keys are perception, developing concentration of mind, contributing to the society at large, divinize their relation from the world, be truth to oneself, to manifest oneness, living selflessly. Swamiji, I am confident our members will follow the above and will not leave any stone unturned to make India, Bharat, a Vishwaguru. One of the most important points Swamiji also referred was with regards to character. And I remember when I was a child, my parents used to say, if money is lost, nothing is lost. But if character is lost, everything is lost. Swamiji, your presence and invoking of blessings to all will help us to see, take our life for the benefit of human society as a whole. As a token of our respect, I request our beloved President and Vice President to present a fruit bouquet and Shahid Ki Beti certificate. We have not seen the God, but we feel their presence through Swamiji and also judges. I also recognize the presence of CS CV Sajivan, ROC Karnataka. Friends, gratitude is the most beautiful way to express all that's in your heart with two words. Thank you. Our own past chairman of Bengaluru chapter, it is said that first impression is last impression. Sharda Madam, a big thank you to you for excellently comparing and marking this as a last impression to all of us. Ashwini, by invoking the Lord and making this conference a big success. I also take this opportunity to thank our chief guest for the inaugural session, guest of honor and keynote speaker for the inaugural session. The main takeaway from the Santosh Hegde sir, justice, former justice of the Supreme Court and former Lokayukta of Karnataka, we may be professional, but most important to be is a human being. Dr. Gururaj Karjagi, value not to be preached, but to be demonstrated. Knowledge, skill, and most important, attitude. The guest of honor also spoke about the many good things about our profession, the recognition, the contribution made by the all our members and all the past presidents, council members, and members as a whole. I would also like to thank all the faculties, who addressed the panelists in various technical sessions. I would also like to thank and having confidence a team ICSI, Central Council members, Regional Council members, chapters for having confidence in Bangalore chapter to hold on its own the National PCS Conference and bringing it to Bangalore. I will fail in my duty if I would not recognize the help, solicitation provided by all these sponsors by virtue of stalls, by virtue of advertisements in souvenirs, by virtue of providing various products, and also by virtue of helping to organize the program in a big way. I also would like to thank all esteemed practicing company secretaries who have helped by virtue of providing in a big way all kind of support, and especially the Bangalore chapter practicing company secretaries, whether it is a younger company secretaries or senior company secretaries, by providing all the help and assistance. All the help and assistance. I would also like to thank the hotel authorities for the sumptuous lunch, dinner, and all the delicacies provided, and also for the pleasant stay provided. My special thanks to Mr. Francis, my special thanks to Mr. Devraj, and also to Mr. Praveen. Friends, I quote the words of Phil Jackson. It says, "The strength of the team is each individual member. The strength of each member is the team." I thank each and every member of Bengaluru chapter. I thank each and every member of Regional Council. I thank each and every member, Central Council members, who have reposed confidence for organizing this particular program. Friends are flowers in the garden of life. I am sure that all the help and assistance which have been provided by them needs also to be recognized. There are many people who work on a background basis which probably most of our members would not know. I would like to request from the Bangalore chapter to kindly come forward so that all our members would also be aware of the dedication, the efforts which have been provided by the team Bangalore. I would request the chapter staff from the Bangalore chapter to kindly come forward. Mr. Maitriya, Ms. Noor, Putraju, Venugopal. They are the great warriors because of whom this conference could be made successful. Friends, we are in the era of technology. We are technology heavy. A great applause to Preeti Banerjee from headquarters. I request her to kindly come forward. It is because of her that the institute is made more aware of. I would also like to ask Mr. Dheeraj Gupta, day in and day out, who has been contributing, sending mails after mails. I think he's still busy to see this conference post the successful of the conference time. I request our joint secretary, Sara Madam, and her entire team to kindly come forward. Sara Madam, Channa Keshava. I cannot forget two people. One, Mr. Putraju, In a humorous way, I would like to say, those who are in Kannada, there is a jodi called as Changu Mangu. So a person will understand whom I am talking to. Venugopal. 24/7. They are here. I am not just saying. I feel that they would not have slept at least for a day or two, when working timelessly and devoting their time, efforts to see that this conference becomes successful. A big round of applause for all our team. Friends, at the inaugural of the conference, somebody mentioned about Kumbh. Sharda Madam mentioned about Kumbh, that it has come 12 years after a gap of 12 years. And in Kumbh, our Vice President said that there are two people we can see. One is Naga Sadhus, and other members are the general local people, members who wants to come and participate for the program. I am indebted to all my registered delegates who have participated, who have made their presence felt, and it is because of you the success of this particular conference, 20th National Conference, is there. It cannot be a dry applause. A big round of applause to you yourself. I'd like to thank the printer for printing an excellent souvenir covering all the magazines, covering all the articles, covering all the advertisement, and also ensuring nobody is missed out. I also would like to thank few members of the ICSI. Shri Ankurji, Shri Samirji, Shri Saurabhji, Mr. Naveen, Sanjeev, Sanjit, it is because of them that this conference is successful. I also recognize and also would like to thank all our members who have given their articles, who have written the articles, not only those members whose article has been printed in the souvenir, but also who have taken time in writing the article which is not published. Friends, for organizing this particular program, this conference, there might be some inconvenience, either by virtue of transport facility, either by virtue of food facility, or either by virtue of coming in the vehicle, or X or Y. I hold myself personally responsible in case of any inconvenience, and I know all of you are big-hearted people. You will forgive me for all those inconveniences. When this conference was being formed, when we required massive support of members, we required massive support of student volunteers. I would request all the student volunteers to kindly come forward. To kindly come forward. Their enthusiasm, zeal, many of my registered delegates had told, At 4 o'clock, I have received a call on 5th that at what time you are coming. We are already there in the railway station. We are there in the airport to pick you up. A big round of applause to them. Ankur, Prasanna, Tukaram, volunteers who are still tirelessly working for benefit of our members outside. So we will congratulate them by applauding over here. Please come. Please come. Lifetime. Whenever in Mahabharata, when Arjuna was under questionable situation as to how to solve an issue, he used to always remember Shri Krishna. I would like to acknowledge sincere thanks, my pranams to C.S. Gopal Krishna Hegde. My pranams to C. Dwarkanath. I would request C.S. Dwarkanath to kindly come forward. My pranams to my dear Haribabu Tota. My pranams to Shashidhar. Shashidhar, please come. My pranams to Dushyant. All our future leaders, come for. I have forgot. Ganapati, please come. Ganapati is the past chairman of. I forget. Is Raghavan. Raghavan sir, please come. These are the few of my strength, my pillars by virtue of which the Bangalore chapter is also proud of. Sir, thank you very much for all your help and support. In case if I would have forgotten anybody, kindly excuse me, but I would like to thank each and every one. The students' conference would be held shortly. The dates are I think finalized. August 17th. I am sure, invoking of blessings of Swami Tatyuktananda Swamiji, invoking blessings will always be there for the students' conference, and it will be also a mega success. I have eaten up more time. I will conclude by saying that thank you very much for all your help and support. We look forward for future programs, future conferences, and I'm sure that Swamiji, whatever have said, we will follow in letter and spirit. Thank you one and all. I would request, before I call all the Central Council members on the dais, I would like to request to kindly arise for the national anthem.
Bharat Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindhu Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchchala Jaladi Taranga तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशिष माहे गाहे तव जय गाथा जनगण मंगल दायक जय हे